We are live from the David S. Mack Arena on the campus of Hofstra University as it is time for a matchup between the Hofstra Pride and the Towson Tigers. Kenny Conrad here alongside me is Victoria Conway. And Victoria, coming into this game, Hofstra coming off a pretty tough loss against UNCW, 87-79 their last time out on the road. And it was a game that was, like I said, a tough loss because UNCW comes in way below Hofstra in the conference.
It was definitely an upset for UNCW, but you have to give them credit for going out there and giving it their all. It was senior night, which definitely added to the emotions in their arena. It's always a tough place for Hofstra to play. Coach Mihalik even said going into it that week that it would be a very hostile environment, and quite frankly, they didn't deserve to win. UNCW outplayed them from the beginning of the game to the end, and that's what happens. You can't overlook any team in the CAA. No matter what their record is, everyone's competitive. And if you're Hofstra, Kenny, you know there's a big target on your back. You've been the talk of the CAA nonstop. Every team wants to knock you down.
And they're the only team that's really gotten a ton of coverage nationally this season. So when you say that, I mean, I completely agree with you. UNCW came into that game with certainly the ability to, even if they're not going anywhere in the conference tournament, even if, you know, nothing really goes their way there, they can at least come out of this season and say, hey, we knocked off Hofstra at home on senior night. So obviously I think that had a lot to do with it.
100%. And Devontae Kaycock, you know what type of force he is down low, and he gives every team a problem, a matchup issue, and he did a great job making sure his Seahawks are ready to go on senior night. And for the Pride, when you think about it, two of their last three losses to UNCW have been pretty painful. You lose in the quarterfinals last year in the CAA tournament, then you avenge that loss here at home, but then they head to the road, and you have to give the Seahawks credit. They could have easily said, okay, here comes Hofstra, they're rolling hot, they got the best player in the CAA, not going to be an easy victory for us. But they gutted it out, and truthfully, there was a moment where the Pride were almost close. They cut down the lead to about 4 or 5, but besides that, they were out of this contest right. The entire time.
And when you look at that game, Justin Wright Foreman, 30 points. We'll talk a little bit more about him in a little bit. And the other game that came on that road trip down south last week for Hofstra was the game against Charleston. Really tough, hard-fought matchup between the two teams. And Charleston's a team that really almost gives everyone trouble in the CAA. They're a great team. They play very well. And it was really a huge road victory for Hofstra. They take it 99-95. What did you see from the Pride in that one, Victoria?
I think the fact that they put up 99 points against Charleston, a team who's in the top of the CAA right. when it comes to defense, is incredibly impressive, because we all know, following this team, how they are able to score and score in bunches. But the fact that they did it on the road in Charleston, and that was a huge momentum win for them just to start off that road trip, and also realize in 2 weeks they're going to be back down in Charleston trying to get to the big dance, and to have a victory, even though it's not in the same arena, still a huge win to know we can come down to Charleston, even though they're going to have the stadium packed with their fans. We can still come out victorious. And quite frankly, it was surprising that there was such a letdown performance Saturday, because if anything, you thought, okay, maybe they'll lose to Charleston, just right. like they had lost to Northeastern, the two teams that were projected to finish before them in the CAA standings. Mm-hmm. And then you have that letdown performance against UNCW. But you do have to remember, you did things right on this road trip to mm-hmm. begin, get back to those things, because Towson defensively plays very similar to right. the Charleston Cougars.
And before we get to what Coach Mihalik said about tonight's matchup, I want to talk a little bit about Justin Wright Foreman. I know we talk about him all the time, but his last three games, Victoria, have just been absolutely phenomenal. First, just over 2 weeks ago, you get 48-point, just absolutely magical performance here at the MAC against William & Mary, and he follows that up with two 30-point performances on the road. So when you put that all together, 36 points per game he's averaging over his last three. What have you seen from him over this little stretch that he's always great, but has made him just so, like, above and beyond great?
I mean, when you have 80 straight games in double figures, obviously you're doing something right. But it just gets to the point where you're so good that when you score 16 and 15, which were the two totals he had before that William & Mary performance, it's like, oh, okay, Justin's got below 20. What's going on? Even though right. he still contributed, the team still won those games. It's just that's the standard of excellence he is holding himself to. And rightfully so, because you saw that William & Mary game. When they needed him most, he took over. And Coach right. Mihalik said post-game during that game, he was not going to let us lose. There's a lot of players out there that weren't going to let us lose, but number three was going to make sure we got the job done. And we were at this game, Kenny. This entire arena, every time he had the ball in his hands, you knew the ball was going in. It was incredible. Every shot, he could create space. They would find him open on the wings, and William & Mary had no answer for him. And then to go to Charleston, a team that you know they scout and double-team him constantly, 30 points, UNCW, good defensive team sometimes, another 30 spot. He's just taking it to another level as we're getting closer and closer to the big dance.
And that's the unbelievable team, is not only to, you know, does he have a target on his back and the team have a target on their backs in the CAA play, but teams like Charleston and Northeastern, how many times have they faced Wright Foreman at this point? You know, his sophomore, junior, and senior year, plus CAA tournament play. I mean, he's just seen these teams so many times, but he's so good at not only making shots, but also making other players around him better and getting his shots off in tight spaces.
Well, that's the best part. You would love to play on this team if you were Eli Pemberton, DeJour Bowie, because the focus is on Justin, and rightfully so. They need to make sure that they try and control him, that they're going to have open looks. And you look at Pemberton, last two games, he's had 20 points back-to-back games. Maybe that's a sign of things getting going for Pemberton. He's had some stretches where he's had those 20-point performances and then some letdown performances. But when you have Justin Wright Foreman on your team, when everyone in the nation has their eyes on him, it's just going to benefit the entire team, and rightfully so. You need to make sure, if you're Wright Foreman, don't push your shots when you don't have it, which he's done a very good job about making sure he's selective, and then when he needs to, he takes over. Pass that ball around, because you're going to get open looks, and especially with how the bigs have been playing this season, feeding off of Bowie, feeding off of Wright Foreman, should be a perfect recipe for success if you're the Pride.
And you mentioned it for Eli. He was Hofstra's second leading scorer in both those road games, 25 at Charleston and then 22 at UNCW in that Hofstra loss. So before we dive into this Towson Tigers team, who comes into this one having a bit of a rough season, a lot of new players, and is sitting sixth in the CAA. Let's take a look at, or let's take a, you know, a look. I guess a look. We're not on radio and TV, so we can take a look.
They're confusing us lately. I know. We got a camera on us. We got microphones. I don't know.
It's all right. We'll be okay. So let's. I want to hear your thoughts. You spoke to Coach Mihalik before the game. What did you hear from him? What are some things you took away from your time talking to the Hofstra head coach?
Well, the first thing I asked him was, last time your team came off a loss, that was when they were on the road at Northeastern, they came home and absolutely blew out Elon. I mean, right. It was a ridiculous performance, 20-2 run to begin the game. And I said, offensive explosion. He said, you know, Victoria, I'm actually going to say it was a defensive performance. We made sure we limited Elon's best player, Tyler Sebring. We shut him down, and we stuck to our game plan. So he said, energy, we're going to come out angry. Not in a bad way, in a positive way. We're upset. We did not put our best performance on the floor last Saturday, and it taught us that anyone can lose in this conference on any day, so we need to take every game as serious as we've taken when we were on that 16-game win streak.
Right.
So that was first off. Then we got into a little bit about the energy here at the MAC. I mean, perfect season so far this year. Have not lost here since February 3rd, 2018. It's a tremendous stretch, and he said, the last 6 years I've been saying how much I enjoy playing here, but he said the best part has been the fact that fans have come out, and we noticed that. Against William and Mary, this place was packed. The best energy I've ever seen. Mm-hmm. They've had two sellouts this season, first time since 2010, 2011, when Charles Jenkins was patrolling the floor, that they had two sellouts in a season. So it's just that energy, and I think, Kenny, it goes back to winning cures all. When you win, you're going to get that attention. You're going to get the turnout, and that's exactly what the Pride have done. And lastly, to wrap it up, I said, you learned quickly Saturday that even though some of these teams might be below 500, in the CAA, middle of the pack teams, anyone can win. He said, absolutely. And Towson, one of the most difficult things is we beat them by a lot on their home floor. You don't think they want to come up here and avenge that loss? Absolutely. So we have to make sure that we come out with that same energy, because they're going to try and get back at us and feed off of our home court advantage.
And it's a similar thing that I talked about with UNCW. Towson's a team that typically wins 18 games or more. They've done so for the last five seasons. But this year, they're not going to. They're only 10-18 coming into this game. But as we get closer to the conference tournament, a win against Hofstra boosts their resume. It boosts their confidence out there. And again, it's just something that you can kind of put on your schedule and say, hey, you know what? We beat Hofstra this year. They were the best team in the conference. So again, it's a game where Hofstra can't look forward to senior day, which is Saturday, mm-hmm. and they have to really focus on the task at hand tonight. That's Towson.
And that's crucial, because we already know how emotional this place is going to be Saturday. And it's going to be an amazing day for the seniors, and especially Justin Wright Foreman. You never want to just single out one player, but it's safe to say he is a once in a, you know, we are fortunate we get to call games watching him take over, especially that 48-point performance. So that's going to be a lot of emotions, a lot of excitement. But right now, you need to win, because if Hofstra wins the next two games, they at least clinch a share of first place in the CAA for the regular season, mm-hmm. which would be huge. So that means they just have to win one more game next week to be outright champions, which is what they want to do. They've never done that in program history. So stay focused tonight, Thursday. Then you worry about senior day. And as Coach Mihalik loves to say, you worry about two games. Last week, Saturday, and tonight, and that's what the Pride should look to do.
So let's take a look at Towson. They come into tonight 10-17 overall, 6-8 in conference play, and 6th place in the CAA on the road so far this year. They're 4-6 and 3-4 in conference play. And Victoria, it seems like they're kind of led by a 1-2 punch, if you will, of Brian Fobbs and Tobias Howard. They seem like they're kind of their two biggest forces. What do you see out of this Tigers team?
Well, the Tigers team, very fresh, very new faces. When I was doing some prep work, I realized they had 4 transfers, 11 freshmen. So when you talk about youth and inexperience, maybe that's why the 10-18 record, because before that, Towson's always been in the middle of the pack to the top of the league. Last year, they gave Hofstra fits last season, and this year you saw Hofstra handle them pretty easily in Maryland. But for the Towson Tigers, their key is to get more than 2 players involved. You already mentioned Fobbs and Howard. They do a great job in their first season wearing the Tigers uniform. But if you can get other players involved for Towson, then it becomes a dangerous game because they keep games close, Kenny. Mm-hmm. Defensively, they're at the tops of the league. They do a great job. Their last 3 road games have been decided by 1 point. So that just shows you how close they are. So if they get those 2 extra points from a bench player or somebody else popping off the bench, like I mentioned, I mean, their bench scored 20 points against Hofstra last time out, and Hofstra only had 2 points from their bench. That's a big advantage for Towson if they can contribute with that. Dennis Tunsall, somebody who did not really show up last time Hofstra played against the Towson Tigers, can he show up? I think it just goes beyond 2 players. If they can get multiple players involved, they'll be able to put a fight up against Hofstra.
And that game was an 86-61 win for Hofstra over Towson. And Victoria, something that I think is so interesting when you look at it is Towson is 2nd in the conference in scoring defense. They only allow 70.5 points per game. The only team that's better is College of Charleston. And Hofstra shot 55% against them. Teams on average only shoot 42.8% against Towson. So, I mean, just an incredible offensive performance by Hofstra in that game. Not only they did well on the offense, obviously, but defensively, too, to hold them to 61 points.
100%. And right now, Hofstra has shot better than 50% from the floor in 6 of their past 8 games. And they've been averaging 11.5 three balls in their last 4 games. So that's just the clash of a best offensive team and arguably one of the best defensive teams in the CAA. We mentioned last Thursday what a great job Hofstra did against the number 1 scoring defense. 99 points, not too shabby against the Cougars. Can they replicate that against Towson? But I'm most intrigued to see, Kenny, what does Towson try and do to the Pride? Do they try and limit Wright Foreman? Teams have tried, has not worked. Or do they try and try to match their energy offensively and push the ball, push the tempo, maybe do some press early on to Hofstra, get in their head? Because you have to switch up anything you tried last time out because it was clear Hofstra was not bothered by anything.
And we will see what happens when we come back. We will have the national anthem, starting lineups, and tip off here from the Mac Arena. You're listening to all the action right here on GoHofstra.com. are back at the David S. Mack Arena on the campus of Hofstra University. And before we bring you starting lineups and opening tip-off here from Hofstra, we will send it over to the national anthem. David S. Mack Arena on the campus of Hofstra University getting set for this matchup between the Hofstra University Pride and the Towson Tigers again. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway here on the call. Before we go any further, let's bring you the starting lineups. First for the visiting Towson Tigers, in the front court tonight, they'll have Dennis Tunstall and Nakai Sanders, and in the back court, their star player, Brian Fobbs, as well as Alan Beatran and Ja'Kai Dotton. And on the other side for Hofstra, in the back court, it'll be Deshore Bowie, Justin Wright Foreman, and Tariq Coburn, followed up by Eli Pemberton and Ja'Keel Taylor down low at center. So, Victoria, when you look at that starting lineup for Hofstra, obviously it's the lineup they've been going with for a while. You look at Justin Wright Foreman, obviously he's the star, but they've been getting performances from other players. And one guy I really wanted to highlight was Ja'Keel Taylor, because of the way that he has kind of evolved his game throughout the season, and in my opinion, I think he's really improved as the year has gone on.
100%. When he first began back with the Pride, it was obvious he was still trying to get accustomed to the type of offense the Pride run, which is understandable. You can try and replicate it in practice, but until you get those game reps, it's not the same. But all of a sudden, once he started meshing, getting more comfortable with his surroundings, he's been great. Last week, he averaged a double-double, and that's the potential and the type of crafty play he brings. I mean, we've seen him hit jump shots and knock them down at the same time, when you don't always expect it, which is nice from a big... Besides just running the pick and roll, you can also drive to the basket, kick it back out, and he can hit a jump shot, which has been an impressive asset to the Pride. And to your point, I think he might be one of the unsung heroes of this team.
And I completely agree with you. The way that he's been able to come in and replace Rokas Gustis and kind of solidify that paint for the Hofstra Pride this season has been really impressive. And it's been something where it was a question mark heading into the year, because, you know, you looked at it and you said, okay, you have Gui, Wright Foreman, and, you know, Pemberton. You know what you're going to get from them. You know the kind of players they are. But beyond that, you know, what are you going to get from your big man? And he's been phenomenal. Dan Meyer's also been really good when he's been called on in sparing minutes if Taylor's in foul trouble, or, you know, if, you know, whatever is going on in the game, if they want to change things up. So he's been really good. And as you just saw the Towson Tigers lineup come out, what would you say is somebody you're looking out for on this Towson side?
I definitely think Brian Fobbs. I mean, we obviously know the type of player he is. It's a homecoming for him, though. He's from the New York area. I think it'll be very intriguing to see, does he have some family here? Does that get him juiced up? And see what type of performance he can put on, because he did a great job last time out. Him and Tobias Howard, as well as somebody who's coming off a career-high 26 points in the win versus Drexel. Another player to keep your eye out for if you're the Pride.
and a really young backcourt that it's almost the complete opposite of Hofstra when you look at this Towson team as they start two freshmen in the backcourt, excuse me, in Allen Beatrand and Ja'Kai Dotton. I mean, these are two guys who have kind of had to learn on the fly this season a little bit, kind of, you know, develop as the year has gone on. And I think that lately Towson's played some better basketball than they did earlier in conference play, and I think it's a sign of having a young team. And I mean, I think that these young teams are dangerous when you're a team filled with stars and seniors like Hofstra, because, you know, players and teams develop as the year goes on, especially these younger guys. So I think that for Hofstra, coming into this game, maybe this Towson team won't be the same team they saw a few weeks ago. Maybe they've really improved.
And as you get closer and closer to tournament time, you know, in the locker room, your coach is telling you, anyone can win once we get to that tournament. Once we get to Charleston, it's a brand new season. You win three games, that really flips the script of your season. So it has to energize you. That's what's great about the CAA and basketball, college basketball in general. You get that chance, no matter what. Even if you're in dead last, you're still going to get an opportunity to prove that you can go on a run, maybe have a magical ending to your season. You have to. That's why you have to be cautious but not overly the Towson Tigers. Last week, UNCW was in last place. They showed you what they can do. They handled Hofstra pretty handily, and I think that was a great lesson for the pride of them, realizing we need to take every game as if you're playing the number one seed, as if our season depends on it, especially since we're regular season game remaining.
And I think that's something that is really impressive when you look at Towson, just to make one more point about them, is the fact that as a young team, sometimes defense is the thing that kind of comes last. You know, you won't play good defense. And that's been something that they've kind of honed in on this year and say, you know what, even if we don't have the best shooting percentage in the conference or the best offense in the conference, defense, a lot of it's about hard work and just dedication on that side of the ball. And it's clearly something that they've done well as they come in second in defensive scoring. And I think that that's something that can give Hofstra fits them. You know, they did a good job of combating that earlier in the year, but certainly tonight could be something to watch out for.
I think that's a great point, Kenny. Young teams are scrappy and feisty. We've seen that for Towson. They're going to come out with a lot of energy. Let's see how Hofstra tries to rebound from just our second loss in 4 months.
And Hofstra in the home whites, they'll be going from right to left. Towson in the road blacks with yellow trim, they will go left to right as Ja'Keel Taylor and Nakai Sanders get set at center court for the opening tip. So again, the starting lineup for Hofstra: Coburn, Wright, Foreman, Bowie, Pemberton, and Taylor. As we get set to tip off here from the MAC. Tips up, and it's won by Sanders over to Towson. Up the floor with it here is Dotton. He'll dish it near side for Fobbs. Fobbs now going far side for Beatrand up top. Where it's Dotton. Dotton down low inside. Spin move is up and good. And Sanders with the right hand, and the first points go to Towson. Now it's Hofstra with the ball. Right Foreman, top of the key, over for Pemberton. Screen set there by Taylor. Pemberton, top of the key, pulls up, shoots, and that one is no good off front rim. Skying in for the rebound is Coburn. He tips it out over to the far side of the court. They wrestle for it on the ground. It goes out of bounds, and they'll say it is off a Hofstra player. It'll go to Towson.
That was great hustle by Coburn. It looked like he was going to have the easy offensive board and putback, but you have to give credit to the Towson Tigers not slowing down, making sure they grab the rebound, and already a press from the Pride.
Ball's inbounded there to Fobbs. Fobbs guarded by Coburn as he brings it across the timeline. 2-0 Towson. We're just 45 seconds in. Far side of the court, it's Beatrand. Screen set there by Dotton. Beatrand around the screen. Floater from the top. And that one is no good. Rebounded by DeShore Bowie. Bowie looks to push across the timeline. Pulls up the three-point arc. Gives to Pemberton near side. Pemberton on the floor. Stops. Has it stripped. Backs his way into the paint. Puts it up. Left hand. And one. Eli Pemberton getting the scoring started for Hofstra. And he will get one more shot at the free throw line.
Right there, looked like Pemberton was going to send it back out to right corner. It looked like he was open from the left wing. That's a great job by Pemberton, being physical down low. We already mentioned back-to-back 20-point performances from Pemberton. Maybe he's getting hot just at the right time for the Pride.
25 against Charleston and 22 on Saturday against UNCW as he sinks the free throw. 3-2 Hofstra. We're just a minute five in. Here it's Beatrand, guarded by Coburn. Hofstra again going with a little press there in the backcourt. It's Fobbs, top of the key, guarded by Wright Foreman. Dishes far side for Beatrand. Now it's Dotton, top of the key. Pass inside, up with the right hand, and that's no good. That was Tunstall. And we're going to get a foul there on the rebound. It will go against Towson.
Interesting, Kenny, to start this game already. Towson trying to get to the score within the paint. They have not taken any perimeter shots. They continue to drive and attack Taylor down low.
Bowie across the timeline with it. Gives it back to Coburn, top of the key. Now for Pemberton. Pemberton for Wright Foreman. Guarded there by Dotton aggressively. Wright Foreman, top of the key for three. That one's no good off back iron. Skying up for the rebound is Taylor, but he doesn't grab it. It's Fobbs pushing it up now across the timeline. Shot from left wing three is good. So Fobbs there with a three, and it's 5-3 Towson.
Just as I said, Towson has taken a perimeter shot right there. Good transition offense by the Towson Tigers.
Wright Foreman here, top of the key with the ball. Fishes far side, Bowie steps into a three. That one is no good off front iron. Rebounded by Coburn, he's going to be fouled on the way up. So they'll get Towson on the loose ball foul. And Hofstra will retain possession underneath the hoop.
Again, Coburn doing a great job crashing the boards offensively. And that's another great point. Besides Taylor, who's going to step up and rebound for this team?
So Bowie will inbound from underneath the hoop. 5-3 Tigers. And we're just over 2 minutes into this opening half. Eli Pemberton, the lone 3 points for the Pride, as Bowie gives it to Taylor. Now up top for Coburn. Wright Foreman comes around a screen, has the ball stripped. Ball on the floor. Wright Foreman diving for it. He saves it, but he fell out of bounds with the ball. And this one will go to Towson.
Interestingly enough, every time Wright Foreman's touched the ball, Tigers have been all over him, double-teaming him. So early on, see if he can pass out of that and find the open man.
And you can tell early on here, head coach Kevin Clark's team being very aggressive on the defensive end of the ball. Fobbs, top of the key, now gives it to Dotton. Dotton back to Fobbs. Up top, Dotton puts it on the floor, working against Bowie. Goes into the paint, puts it up with the right hand. No good, too strong. Rebounded by Jaquiel Taylor. Ball in the hands of Pemberton. He pushes it across half court. Top of the key, puts it on the floor. Looks to drive up with the left hand. No good. Rebound fought for and grabbed there by Towson. Tigers look to come the other way as it's Fobbs across the timeline. Fobbs back for Dotton. 20 on the shot clock here. Near side now. Back up top, it's Beatran. Swings it around, and inside there, it's Fobbs catching the ball, but we're going to get a foul called on the floor. And it looks like they'll get maybe Eli Pemberton there on the call.
Right there, first foul for the Pride against the Tigers. You can already see the game plan. Try and attack through the middle, right by the CA logo. It seems like every possession has ended up there. See if they make an adjustment. Hofstra's still in the 2-3 zone from the inbound.
Pardon me, that foul against Bowie as the ball's inbounded from underneath the hoop by Towson. Fobbs, top of the key, 16 on the shot clock for the Tigers. Now on the near side, it's Howard, just checked in. Inside for Dotton, up top, back for Fobbs. Fobbs puts it on the floor, drives inside, loses the ball on the way up, and it's grabbed by Coburn. Hofstra looking to push. He's got Wright Foreman on his right. Coburn to the rack, no good, no foul called. And it's rebounded by Towson. Howard dishing it near side, it's Fobbs. Looked like he might have traveled, no call by the official. Inside here, Sanders with a turnaround shot from the free throw line. That's good, 7-3 Towson.
You saw the Pride not able to cash in on their transition opportunity. Towson taking it right back the other way.
Bowie, screen set by Taylor at the top of the key. Dishes it far side, it's Wright Foreman for three. That one rattles in. Justin Wright Foreman with his first points of the day. Now 7-6 Towson.
That one almost rattled out, but Wright Foreman with the perfect touch. Took the contested shot, which we know he can knock down with anybody. Right in his face.
Dwyer and Ray set to check in for the Pride. As the top of the key, it's Fobbs. Guarded by Wright Foreman. Hofstra again, that 2-3 zone. Howard around the screen, puts it up, no good off right iron. Rebounded by Tunstall over Pemberton, and he puts it back. 9-6 Tigers.
Great effort right there by Tunstall. Had perfect positioning right around Elijah Pemberton.
Wright Foreman for Bowie. Back for Wright Foreman, far side. Wright Foreman puts it on the floor inside the three-point arc. Dribble moves, takes a long two. That one rattles out. Rebounded by Sanders. Sanders gives it over to Dotton. Dotton, top of the key. Gives it back for Sanders. The big man will dish it off to Fobbs, near side. 20 on the shot clock. 15:25 to go here in the opening half. Entry pass here to Sanders, battling against Coburn. Puts it up right hand, off glass and in. Good defense by Tariq Coburn, but a better shot there by Sanders. Wright Foreman here, far side, gives it to Bowie in the corner. Bowie puts it on the floor, dribbles inside, dish out Coburn. Near corner three, too long. Taylor tips it out, but it's grabbed there by Sanders. Gives it up for Howard across the timeline. Pull up three, top of the key, it's good. Tobias Howard looking to build off that career high performance on Saturday. And it's now 14-6 Tigers here in the first half.
He averaged 20.5 points per game last week, continuing that hot shooting. Howard came off the bench already contributing for Towson.
Wright Foreman, top of the key, screen set by Taylor. Wright Foreman looking to pass it, goes far side for Bowie, but it's too high. off his hands and out of bounds. And we will take a timeout. 14-6 Tigers, 14:37 to go here in the opening half. You're listening to all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
Is it? This is the time of year when everything is on the line. There's no welcome when or go home. March Madness is just around the corner. The CAA Women's Basketball Tournament is coming to the University of Delaware March 13th, 16th, 10 teams, one goal, crown champion. Go to caasports.com for more information.
Coming back in five. Seven to go here in the opening half between Hofstra and Towson. And Victoria, it's Towson off to a surprising, bit of a surprising start this one. They're shooting the ball pretty well, 60% from the field, and they lead 14-6.
And right now, Hofstra really can't get into an offensive rhythm. Defensively, they're being challenged down low. They've had some good defensive possessions, but Towson has done a better job manning up and getting that ball to fall in, especially down low in the paint. But on the offensive side, Kenny, it just seems like a lot of isolation basketball, a lot of shooting early in the shot clock, so instead of waiting and making Towson's defense break down. But you have to credit the Tigers. Shooting performance. They had some good looks from three, but are only shooting one of five from beyond the arc. Often only around 37-38% mark in the CAA play when it comes into the train ball. Right now, out of the timeout, let's see what they can do defensively, trying to get that ball back and maybe slow down the rhythm.
And right now, Towson on a 7-0 run here over the last minute 15. Hofstra showing a couple new people in their five here coming out of the timeout. It's Bowie, Wright, Foreman, Pemberton, as well as Ray and Dwyer, the two newcomers to the game. As here it's Howard pushing it across half court for Towson. Gives it up for Dot. Now near side, it's Fobbs. Fobbs back up top for Howard. Dishes inside. We checked into the game. That's Alex Thomas. Goes back up top. 15 on the shot clock here. Now near side, it's Fobbs. Fobbs got it guarded by Wright Foreman. Screen set there by Dotton. Fobbs with five on the shot clock, near side. Now it's Dotton with three, guarded by Wright Foreman. Puts it on the floor, drives inside with two on the shot clock. Shots up, no good, it won't count. As it's going to be a charging violation there, taken by Justin Wright Foreman. Hofstra ball.
Nice job by Wright Foreman. As you can see right there, Dobbs is trying to get down low in the paint. Nice job taking the charge. Maybe that's a defensive stop Hofstra needs to try to get things going the other way offensively.
Wright Foreman here for Ray. Ray dishes it off for Bowie, top of the key. Dwyer sets a screen. Bowie goes around it, sends it now far corner. It's Ray. Over the top, that one well short, off of Pemberton's hands, and out of bounds on the rebound. It will go back to Towson.
And Kenny, this game is early. It's about 5 minutes, 7 minutes in. It's reminded me a lot of the Northeastern loss where they just could not get different shots to fall and they weren't making adjustments. Right now, still plenty of time, obviously. Let's see if they can try and drive to the basket because their perimeter game right now is not falling.
Hofstra 1 of 6 from beyond the arc so far, and Townsend now on a 7-0 run over the last 2 minutes of basketball. Here it's Howard, top of the key, dishing it off now for Fobbs. Fobbs back up top for Howard, screen set. Howard looking to go inside here, but he loses the handle. Stolen by Wright Foreman, looks to push it up, and he's just going to slow things down. Takes it across half court. Up top for Pemberton. Pemberton on the floor, takes to the hoop, puts it up with the right hand, no good. But he's going to be fouled on the play, so two shots coming from Eli.
And we've already seen Eli drive to the basket three or four times, so he's not settling back for the long ball. He's just making sure to get to the basket, using that big frame that he has. And something interesting with Eli Pemberton is in the beginning of the season, Coach Mihalik said he believed he was just thinking too much. He was putting too much pressure on himself, but once he stopped and relaxed and got his focus, he started playing well as he knocks down the first free throw to end a 7-0 scoring run by Towson. But Kenny, that's the biggest thing with some of these players is you put so much pressure on yourself. Obviously, you want to compete and you want to try and help out Justin Wright Foreman scoring-wise. But when you just make things simple, you start playing basketball like you've done your whole life, things work out as he knocks down second free throw.
And he's certainly, as you get closer to the CAA tournament, I mean, he's obviously a huge piece for Hofstra, as here it's Howard across half court. Howard guarded by Wright Foreman. Hofstra again showing that 2-3 zone. As up top of the key, it's McNeil. Just checked into the game for Fobbs. Screen set by Thomas. Fobbs looked like he threw an arm there. Puts up the three. No good. Right, Foreman hit the deck. No foul called as Ray grabs the rebound. Ray loses the handle on it, but it goes to Pemberton. Pemberton, far side for Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman in the far corner puts up a three. That one's good. Justin Wright Foreman feeling it from that far corner, and it's 14-11 Tigers.
Right there, great defense. You can't complain if you're head coach for the Towson Tigers, but Wright Foreman just showing that sweet stroke that he has. Very consistent shooting.
Inside, Fobbs, spin move on Dwyer, puts it up with the left hand and in. Nice little move there by Fobbs, and early on here, he's got 5 points. Ray, near corner three. That one's good. Jalen Ray's first points of the game off a quick possession there from Hofstra. 16-14 Towson.
Ray did not score against UNCW. Nice to see him get on the stat sheet early on.
That's Howard, top of the key. Guarded by Wright Foreman. Howard puts on a dribble, gives it to Fobbs. Fobbs, again, with Wright Foreman draped all over him. Comes around a screen there, puts up a long three, does Fobbs, and it's good. So the lefties trading three-pointers here as it's now. They won't give a three there. 18-14 Towson, so a long two for Fobbs. Bowie, far corner, puts it on the floor. Dwyer with a screen, gives it up top. They swing it. Now it's Wright Foreman, near corner three. That one's no good. Rebound by Dan Dwyer. Dwyer kicks it out up top. It's Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman gives it to Pemberton. Top of the key for three. No good, too long. And that one is grabbed by Howard on the rebound.
Nice job by Wright Foreman, kicking it back out. Great look for the Pride, so you'll take that every time because eventually you expect your shooters to be able to knock down the open look.
McNeil inside for Fobbs, back outside for Howard for three. That one's no good, off back iron, and the offensive rebound grabbed there by Fobbs. Both teams shooting a lot of threes early, already 16 three-pointers between these two teams. Near corner here, now it's McNeil again for three. That one off the mark, rebound grabbed there by Thomas out of the hands of Dwyer. It rolls out of bounds, and this one will go to Hofstra. 18-14 Towson with 11:04 to go here in the opening half. You're listening to all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
To the next level with a graduate degree at Hofstra University. Choose from nationally ranked MBA programs, fully accredited mental health programs, and graduate programs in healthcare, communications, science, counseling, education, and more. Take advantage of flexible class schedules, state-of-the-art campus facilities, or online classes, and experiential learning. Learn more at a graduate open house. Visit hofstra.edu/gradTV.
Campus of Hofstra University. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway on the call. And since the last media timeout, Victoria, I think that Hofstra has certainly maybe put a little bit better foot forward, especially on the offensive end. They've raised their field goal percentage a little bit, but both teams taking a lot of three-pointers here in the early going.
It's been an interesting game to watch because you'd expect Towson to try and slow it down, maybe drive down the open paint, which is what they did for the first few minutes. But then all of a sudden, it was run-and-gun offense for both teams, just trading shots left and right. And if you're Hofstra, you might want to get into that type of matchup because you know Towson does so well defensively. You can get quick shots off and you have the scores, you have the ability to make those shots. That might bode well for the Pride. But if Towson, you have to be happy about the energy and the peskiness they've shown, especially down low. Every rebound that the Pride have gotten defensively has been fought for. No easy rebounds. There's been some close calls already on the offensive side. Towson doing some good job grabbing those second chance opportunities for their team. So if you're Towson, you're thrilled with the way you've come out so far on the road against the number one team in the CAA.
Towson leading the way in rebounds, 10-7. Each team with two offensive boards so far. As here it's Ray across half court. Taylor's checked back in as well as Coburn. As it's Wright Foreman here on the floor against Fobbs. Up at the left hand, off glass and in. And one, Justin Wright Foreman, 18-16 Towson.
And early on, Wright Foreman was just shooting a lot of three balls, did not drive to the basket. But once he does that, Kenny, once he puts his shoulder down and gets to that hoop, very difficult to slow him down. He's already with 8 points only 10 minutes into this game. 80 straight games in double figures. I mean, you can say it multiple times, but considering this kid didn't even get a chance to start freshman year, really play major minutes, it's really amazing the way he's had such a successful career here as he knocks down the free throw.
18-17 now, Towson. As here it's Beatrand across half court. First time we've seen him so far in this game. Up top for Howard. Howard now near side for Fobbs. He's been on the court for every minute for Towson. Tunstall, 15-footer, no good off back iron. Rebound grabbed out of the air there by Sanders. Sanders back for Tunstall, up with the right hand and good. And one as the foul's called on Jaquiel Taylor. So one more shot coming here for Tunstall.
And right there, Kenny, on that play, it looked like Taylor just put his hand straight up, but we saw when William and Mary was in town, even when Taylor put his hand straight up, he was getting called for the fouls. That'll be interesting to watch as this game progresses. If they go straight up with their hands and they're still calling fouls, have to be careful if you're the bigs for both sides.
So a free throw opportunity for Tunstall. He's got 4 points, make it five on the day. Sanders leading the way big time on the glass right now for Towson. He's got four rebounds so far in this game. As Pemberton here, top of the key, gives it over for Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman puts a move on. Still at the top of the key. Looking to get through the double. Nice bounce pass inside for Taylor. And one! What a bounce pass by Justin Wright Foreman inside. And Taylor gets the lucky roll off iron and in.
I mean, Kenny, when you talk about a bounce pass, that's whatever's beyond the bounce pass in terms of difficulties. That is what it is, right? Beautiful job getting around two defenders as they're trying to stop the pick and roll. But once again, right, if he's not driving to the basket, still doing an amazing job facilitating the ball. And I think that's where he's grown the most. We've always known he could score, but he's doing a great job when he plays the role of point guard as Taylor knocks down the free throw.
And he really is such an incredible distributor. And it's good to see someone who, you know, is really scoring first, but also looks for those opportunities to dish to his teammates. As here, it's Howard, top of the key. 21-20, Towson leads. Just 10 minutes to go here in the opening half. Howard guarded by Wright Foreman here on the near side. Screen set there as Howard pulls up for three. That one's no good off back iron. Again, it's Sanders on the glass as he puts it up with the right hand. And good. So Sanders with an early 8 points here in this game.
Right there, Kenny. If the Pride aren't going to box out, it's going to be a lot of easy buckets for the Tigers.
Gray, top of the key for Pemberton. Dish inside. Nice pass. Ray up. He's fouled. Shot no good, but a nice find by Eli underneath the basket.
And Jalen Ray, Kenny, somebody that I think gets completely forgotten on this team. Sometimes we talk about unsung heroes. He's someone that always consistently gets in the game for about 15, 16 minutes. And some games, he looks like he's the best shooter on the floor. Of course, he struggled at times, knocks down that free throw. But since he's been a part of this Hofstra Pride team, and it's difficult when you come from high school where you're starting every day, he has contributed time and time again for the Pride, and he's one of the best sharpshooters they have. If they get him going as it gets close to tournament time, such a dangerous sixth man off the bench as he knocks down both free throws.
As up top of the key here, it's Dotton for Towson. There's going to be a foul call there on Ray at the half court line. So it'll be Towson ball here on the far side out of bounds. As it's inbounded to Howard, he pulls it across half court. 20 on the shot clock for Towson. Now it's Beatrand back on the near side. Dotton guarded there by Wright Foreman. Goes around a screen. Still here at the top of the key. Dishes it now far side. It's Howard. Howard guarded by Ray. 5 on the shot clock. He's got to make a move. Puts it on the floor. Drives inside. Foul going to be called on the floor here. As it looks like they'll get Jalen Ray. And a short buoy. Looks like he's ready to check back in for Hofstra. Ray will sit.
Once again, Howard being very aggressive. Towson making sure that he has the ball in his hands. And he obviously is a very good scorer coming off of that career high performance I've already mentioned. See what Hofstra can do to try and slow him down.
Inbound here for Beatrand. Fresh 20 seconds here on the shot clock for Towson. Dotton, far side. Back up top. Now Towson puts it on the floor. Dotton, bounce pass inside. And that one's blocked by Taylor. That was Oyelamu going up there. As Wright Foreman here. Top of the key, gives it for Bowie. So big block on Oyelamu there by Jaquiel Taylor. Bowie on the floor, brings it inside, dishes it now. Top of the key, Pemberton around the screen. Looks to go inside and put it up. And we're going to get a jump ball called there in the air as it got tied up with Howard. Possession arrow favors Hofstra.
Again, Pemberton trying to be aggressive, taking it to the basket. You have to credit Howard, though. Nice job switching it down low, making sure he did not allow Pemberton to have the easy layup.
So Bowie will inbound, 12 on the shot clock here as Coburn comes out on screen, far corner three, no good, but he's fouled on the play. Lots of fouls here from Towson as they're already up to 9 here in this half. And Coburn will take 3 free throws.
Tariq Coburn doing a great job this season for the Pride, even though his last time out, he just had 4 points against UNCW. And I think it's safe to say when he has gone right, he's done a tremendous job being that third piece for Pemberton and Wright Foreman as he hits the first free throw. Coming in as a transfer student, had to try to find ways to get used to this offense and fit in. And he's done a great job after sitting out last season, making sure to contribute to the Pride's offensive explosion this season as he drains the second free throw.
And Colbert's a guy who at the beginning of the year didn't get much playing time, but coach said you have to rebound. If you want to play, if you want to get in the lineup, you have to learn how to rebound. And he's really done it so far. And he had a couple performances in the non-conference slate where he just came out and ate glass. And that has been really a main reason as to why he's been getting so much playing time and in the starting lineup here as he misses the final free throw. 24-23 Hofstra as it's Fobbs with the ball for Towson. Beatrend near side, guarded by Wright Foreman, gives it up to Dotton. Dotton inside, puts it up, no good. Big rebound there over the top by Sanders. They're going to call a foul. Looks like they'll get Eli Pemberton on that one.
Again, Sanders has already said it, Kenny's got 6 rebounds in this game, and it seems like every time the Tigers have put a shot up, he's right below patrolling down low. And outside of Taylor, there's been nobody else really step up for the Pride to try and get some boards.
Only other rebound for Hofstra so far in this game, 1 for Coburn and 1 for Bowie, but you're right, Victoria, 3 for Taylor. He's been the only guy who's really been able to get a lot of rebounds. So 30 on the shot clock for Towson. As here, pass inside, Sanders puts it up, off glass and in. And they're going to tee up Sanders there as he kind of stared down Taylor after he made that shot. So a good start to the game for Sanders, but he's got to cool it there as he gets teed up. So Bowie will take the free throws for Hofstra.
And Hofstra would love to have those opportunities to shoot free throws. They're on pace to break the program record for free throw percentage from the line. 2010-2011 team had 76%. Right now they're currently sitting at 79.8% as Bowie misses.
You jinxed it.
Yeah, I did. My goodness. Even though I was told yesterday there's no such thing as a jinx. I don't know if I believe it.
You jinxed him there as Bowie, when you stop talking about it, knocks down the free throw. So 25 all here between Hofstra and Towson. So Sanders is going to take a seat here. He's been dominant in the early going as he leads Towson in points with 10 and rebounds with 6. Coburn here, far side, gives it up top for Bowie, now near side Pemberton. Coburn cuts around a screen. Pemberton elects to go to Wright Foreman. Over for Bowie, far side. Bowie puts it on the floor, dish inside Taylor, up with the left hand. That one's good. And it's 27-25 Hofstra.
Nice job by Taylor maintaining his composure as down low they tried to shift over and have a last minute block to no avail. Good job by the Pride sending the ball down low.
Dish inside here, it's Dotton. Dotton take the 15-footer. That one's no good, off back iron. Rebounded by Taylor. Hofstra looking to get a little breathing room here early in this first half. As Wright Foreman gives it near corner, it's Coburn, no good. That three is too long. And the rebound's grabbed by Towson. Dotton, top of the key. Guarded there in the 2-3 zone for Hofstra. As on the far side now, it's Beatrend. Turned up top for Fobbs. Gives it now for Dotton. Now Fobbs back, gets the ball back on the far side. Fobbs with 8 seconds to go here on the shot clock. Puts up the three near wing, and it's good. Right in the face of Eli Pemberton. Fobbs knocks down the three. 28-27 Tigers.
Fobbs leading the way in double figures, and he's had 20 games in which he's led the Tigers in scoring. Well on his way to doing more of the same in this game.
Wright Foreman up top to Bowie. Bowie at the logo. Gives it to Pemberton. Bowie puts a dribble move on, gives it to Pemberton. Now near corner three on the way from Wright Foreman. That one's no good, short. Rebound grabbed by Pemberton. And they're going to call a foul. And they will get Brian Fobbs there on the foul. So for Fobbs here in the early going, that's his second foul of the game. And we will take a timeout. 28-27. Towson leads, 6:27 to go here in the opening half. You're listening to all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
time to register for Saturday classes for young people. Hofstra Continuing Education offers a variety of programs for your child. Students can get help in math, reading, and writing. Like video games and coding, we have you covered. Enjoy the arts, check out cartooning, theater, and studio arts, sports classes, swimming, and more. Take your child's education to the next level with science, pre-collegiate, and gifted programs. Register today online or call 516-463-7400.
The Tigers with a 28-27 lead. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway on the call here. And Victoria, when you look at this game so far, you kind of said it during the timeout. It's been a bit of a weird like kind of game so far. It hasn't had that much of a flow. There's been a lot of free throws for Hofstra. They've already taken 12, and Hofstra really not shooting the ball well from the field. Right now, 35 from the field and 25 from beyond the arc.
And that's not much of a surprise, though, if you're a fan of the Tigers. You already know coming into this game, they do a tremendous job holding opponents on the floor shooting-wise. They have a top-ranked field goal defense in the CAA, holding opponents at 42.8%. And the Pride have the top-ranked field goal offense at 49%. But so far, it's been Towson with the advantage. But if you look up at the scoreboard, Hofstra's just down one, right? Foreman is getting into a group a little bit, but still not hitting all of his shots like you're accustomed to him doing. Besides, right, Foreman, especially on the boards, Kenny, that is where Hofstra needs to focus.
And Hofstra will shoot two free throws every time that Towson commits a foul for the rest of this half. As Pemberton's first free throw's up and good. 28 all now. And that pulls Eli Pemberton ahead of Mike Tilley on the all-time Hofstra scoring list. 1,287 points. He's now in 18th place, so congrats, Eli. So 28 all as he misses the first free throw. And it's Dotton across the timeline. Back up top, it's Beatrick, guarded there by Wright Foreman. Dotton back up top, it's Fobbs, guarded there by Trueheart. First we've seen him for Hofstra. Fobbs puts it on the floor inside, swatted away by Trueheart. And Hofstra will come the other way. Wright Foreman puts a dribble move on, but loses it off the foot of Taylor. And Townsend will grab it and come the other way. It's Dotton, bounce pass down low, Fobbs with a left-handed jam. And it's 30-28 now, Tigers lead.
Third turnover of the game for Wright Foreman. Very uncharacteristic of him. Let's see if he can settle down. Even though he has 9 points, you don't want to see those turnovers from Wright Foreman.
Justin with the ball here on the near side. Dishes it now far side. Ray gives it for Trueheart. 12 on the shot clock here for the Pride. Ray. So on the far side, up top it's Trueheart. Steps into a three and it's good. Stafford Trueheart from the top of the key. He's on the board. 31-30 Hofstra.
Trueheart plays the role of a spark plug for this team. You saw him defensively get the swat, and right there he can shoot just as well as anybody else on this Pride team, especially from beyond the arc, even though he plays the four.
Petrain goes far side for Fobbs. Steps into a three, top of the key, it's good. Ryan Fobbs having a nice first half here. He's 6 of 8 from the field, 15 points in the opening frame. Wright Foreman, near side, controlling the offense. With 20 seconds to go here on the shot clock. It's Pemberton, top of the key for Stafford Trueheart. Back up top, Wright Foreman, long NBA range three, no good. Pemberton skies in for the rebound. Goes to put it up, no call, as it goes on the floor, grabbed by Taylor. Dishes back out, far side, Pemberton for three. That one's an air ball, grabbed there by Taylor, puts it up, no good. Rebound, ball fought for, and it's grabbed by Dotton. He looks to push it the other way, but he'll slow it down as there was four Pride players and just one for Towson. And we will have an injury timeout down this side of the floor. As there was a lot of physical play there, it's Alex Thomas, the banged up player for Towson. And he will walk over to the bench, but Victoria, a big battle there for the rebound down low.
weird sequence of events for both teams. Hofstra thought they were about to get an offensive board put back by Taylor. Instead, he kicks it out to Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman tried to settle things, found a wide open Pemberton. But just like other players on this Pride team, Pemberton really not finding a stroke. He's 0-for-4 from beyond the arc, just 1-of-8 from the floor. His only points really coming off of his free throw attempts. And if you're the Pride, that's a very frustrating statistic, because you know when Pemberton gets into those double figures, 20-point range, Hofstra has a very good chance of winning. It can't just all be on Wright Foreman. So right now, Pemberton, with some frustration shooting-wise, let's see if he tries to continue taking it to the basket and getting fouled.
And down this end for the Tigers, it's been really the Sanders and Fobbs show for Towson. And his pass inside here, down low, going up with the right hand is good. That was Oyelamo. And it is now a 35-31 Towson lead. Bowie, top of the key. Calling out a play, gives it to Wright Foreman. Back for Bowie down near side. Taylor comes up and sets a screen. As Bowie fakes a pass, goes back out up top. Now far corner, it's Pemberton. Pemberton puts it on the floor. Just 10 on the shot clock for Hofstra. Wright Foreman slipped up there a little bit. And they're going to get him on a travel. Another turnover there for Justin Wright Foreman. 35-21, Towson leads with 3:47 to go here in the opening half. You can call the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
What to expect when you're expecting?
Today, I'm going to show you how to team your home. First step, add a car key. Right away, somewhere they would never look. Challenges will come up. Be ready for them. Ready? Ready for them. And don't use medication.
You don't have to know it all to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will be just the same.
Out in front, 35-31. Kenny Conrad to Victoria Conway on the call here from the back. And Victoria, I mean, it's been kind of a choppy game overall. I mean, I feel like we've talked about it a few times now, but Hofstra really shooting well below, what they typically do right now, just at 33%. And it's really been a couple second chance points that have saved this from being a much bigger lead for the Tigers.
I mean, Towson has been in control the entire time. They've led it for 13 minutes. About 3 minutes until the half. And Kenny, you're right. Towson's done a great job controlling the tempo of this game. When they've wanted to speed it up, they've taken it the other way and ramped it up. And they've wanted Hofstra to maybe take some more second chance opportunities off the board. They've done that as well. They're doing a great job crashing the boards, also doing a great job making sure they're taking the shots they want. And if you're Hofstra, like you said, you're happy you're only down four, but it's concerning that you have all these open looks and the shots aren't falling once again. What's their backup plan? How are they going to attack the Tigers?
And Townsend's put a lot of pressure on Hofstra down on the defensive end, so it's certainly been a good defensive showing so far for Townsend, something that they didn't do in their first matchup against Hofstra. 15 on the shot clock here. It's Howard for Dotton. Trueheart, Dwyer, Bowie, Wright Foreman, and Pemberton on the floor for Hofstra. 10 on the shot clock now. Near side, it's Howard, guarded by Wright Foreman with 5. Howard puts it on the floor. Inside, goes up with the left hand. No good. They call him on the travel. And that one will go back to Hofstra.
Great job there by Wright Foreman, breaking him down, making sure trying to push him to use his right hand. Nice defense there by Wright Foreman.
Wright Foreman loses the pass here. Ball to the floor, and that one's going to roll out of bounds. It's off of Dotton. And Wright Foreman will drop the pass. So inbound pass coming here for Hofstra.
And you can see the frustration on Wright Foreman's face. He almost had his fourth turnover of the game. Try to get him to settle down so he's not focused on turnovers and can just focus on his offensive game.
Here it's Dwyer giving it up top for Bowie. He'll take the three. That one's good. DeShore Bowie with his first field goal of the day. And it's now 35-34 Towson.
Hofstra finally over the 30% mark from beyond the arc. They were in the low 20s about 5 minutes ago. Nice positive change from the Pride.
Dotton at the logo, gives it to Howard on the far side. Dotton again, top of the key, guarded by Bowie. Near side here, back up top, Dotton for three. That one no good, too long. Rebound grabbed by Oyelamo, and he just puts it right in. Another play there where there was no box out from Hofstra. as Bowie looks to push it the other way. 37-34 Towson. Bowie at the top of the key. Guarded there by McNeil. Gives it over to Pemberton. Screen set by Dwyer. The pass is going to be blocked there by Dotton, but it's off his foot, so they'll get a kickball violation. 20 on the shot clock for Hofstra here with a far side inbound. Bowie up top, back for right Foreman. Justin now over to Pemberton. Screen set by Dwyer for Bowie. Bowie stops, gives it over now near side. Pemberton back up top to Bowie. Drives inside, dishes out far side. It's Spafford Trueheart for three. That one's no good from the corner. Too short as it's grabbed by Towson. And the three is just not really falling for Hofstra here in this opening half as it's Dotton up top for the Tigers. 15 on the shot clock. Dotton near side. It's McNeil. McNeil now in the near corner. That's Howard. Puts it up for three. No good. Rebound. Fought for and grabbed there by Oyelamo over Trueheart. Up top, McNeil for three. That one is an air ball out of bounds. Bodies hitting the deck. And as Dwyer, Trueheart, and Howard are on the floor, and it'll be Hofstra ball.
Hofstra is just getting out, rebounded 19-13. But Kenny, when a shot goes up, it looks like Towson is all over the boards. While Hofstra right there, two players on the floor, still trying to just get up off the ground to try and grab that board. Definitely something going into the half. You wonder if they can make that adjustment, maybe come out a little bit more physical, because they'd only have five fouls, against the Tigers.
Pemberton, top of the key. Hofstra trailing by three. A minute and 25 to go. Dwyer swings it. Far side, Bowie for three. That's good. DeShore, Bowie, two straight three-pointers, and we are 37 all with a minute 15 to go in the opening half.
Great feed there by Dwyer, who's at the free throw line. Didn't even try to dribble it. Just sent it right back out to Bowie.
Dotton for McNeil here on the near side. Gives it back to Dotton. Now over for that is Tunstall. Gives it up top. It's Dotton. Looking to go inside. Pass deflected and stolen away. It's Bowie. Bowie pushing the floor. Gives to Pemberton. Goes up for the two-handed slam. Eli Pemberton with the jam, and he stares at the Hofstra Lions' den. 39-37 Pride lead.
Great transition offense by the Pride. Great defense on the other end to get it started, and you can see it right there on the replay. No one was getting in the way of Pemberton's two-handed slam. And Kenny, maybe right there before the half, this is the type of energy jolt the Pride need. It seemed like Towson was the one putting in the extra effort to get to every ball. Maybe changing things under a minute right now as the Pride got a much-needed 2 points.
And I have no statistic to back this up, but that just feels like it was the easiest, or like the only easy basket of the half for Hofstra. I mean, it seems like they have constantly had to work when it comes down to the offensive end for their shots, and it just almost feels like a breath of fresh air. They're able to just push the floor, easy two-handed dunk, and you move on. You know what I mean?
Definitely. For the Pride, something that just seemed like fun and easy.
Right.
Every other shot contested or driving to the bucket, getting banged up and heading to the line. That's a very good way to put it, Kenny. We don't have a stat, so, you know.
I don't have a stat, but I'll just give you my feelings on how things are looking as Bowie deflects the inbounds pass. He does that like twice a game, so you're due for maybe one more here in this. 21 minutes left. As here it's Dotton pushing it across the timeline, guarded by Bowie. 20 on the shot clock, 42 on the game clock here in the opening half with the Pride leading 39-37. Far side, it's Howard, guarded by Bowie, 10 on the shot clock now. As Fobbs, screen set there. Fobbs goes around it, pulls up, long twos, no good. Barely clips the rim, and it's grabbed by Pemberton. Shot clock turned off, Hofstra leading by two, 20 seconds to go here in the opening half. Hofstra calling out a play, Bowie at the logo, now 15 left. Again, shot clock turned off here, final possession of the half for Hofstra. Bowie calls out his play. 6 seconds. Gives it for right Foreman. Right Foreman with four. Gonna have to make a move. He gives it over to Bowie. Bowie looking to swing it. Puts up a long three, and that one's no good. Now off to the left. Nothing doing there on that last possession for Hofstra. And they will take a 2-point lead, 39-37, to the locker room here at halftime at the David S. Mack Arena.
Well, considering the way this game began, Kenny, you have to be happy if you're the Pride having the lead. At the start, Towson had a lot of energy. They were getting that extra effort to get to the ball, get those second chance opportunities. And for the Pride, it was a very slow half shooting. They finally got up to 33% from beyond the arc, but from the floor, under 40%. We're more about a 50% shooting team from the floor. But you have to give credit to the Towson Tigers doing a great job defensively. It seems like every time Hofstra has put up a shot, it's been a hand in their face or they've gotten banged up. A very physical first half by Towson.
And that's something that, you know, kind of shows there's a disparity between the way these two teams play. Towson is a defensive-first team. Hofstra's a very good defensive team. We're not taking anything away from them, but Towson really focuses on that defensive end of the floor first. And like we mentioned, they're second in scoring defense so far this season at 42%. So, I mean, I think that when you look at it, the way that Hofstra shot against them, 55% the first time they played, wasn't really sustainable, but I think that something in the middle is what you'll find Hofstra at in this half. I don't think 38% is a good representation of Hofstra's offense.
Especially because there was some looks that they had wide open and just weren't hitting their shots. Specifically, Pemberton struggled a little bit from the floor, just 2 of 9 in that first half. Definitely like to see him get some more energy, get it going. So take it to the basket several times and get fouled. And that's the type of energizer bunny he can be for this team. Right, Foreman, just 9 points. He's had 4 turnovers, frustrating first half for Justin Wright Foreman. But we've seen him have slow first halves and then come out of the second half on fire.
And again, Justin on a run of 3 straight games where he's had 30 or more points. So he will certainly, I think, be primed for a bigger second half than he had first half. So final lines, some stats on this half, right? Foreman with 9, Bowie with 7, Pemberton with 8. They're your 3 leading scorers for Hofstra. And on the other side, we didn't see any really of Sanders after he took that technical foul. And he was really dominating the game there early on as far as the glass goes and everything like that. Bobs is the leader for Towson with 15 points. And, I mean, Victoria, I think that when you look at Towson's half, compared to Hofstra's, I think Towson will be really happy with the way they played this first half. They asserted themselves defensively, and they did a pretty nice job offensively.
And they've done it without Howard really getting going. He just has 3 points. You have Fobbs with 15, Saunders with 10. That's a great sign if you're Towson because you know Howard has the ability to turn it on and get scoring and create a big problem for Hofstra in the second half. So you're only down 2 on the road in a hostile environment. I think that's a job well done if you're the Tigers, especially considering you were sort of blown out the last time the two teams met up. I have to be happy with that and see what adjustments they make. I think defensively they're fine. Offensively, though, they had a lot of looks that just weren't their preferred shot. They kind of just chucked it up, looking a little bit frazzled offensively instead of settling down to try to get an offensive rhythm established.
We're going to step aside. We will be back in a bit with the second half of action here from the MAC again. After 20 minutes of play, 39-37, Hofstra leads. You're listening to all the action right here and as well as watching on GoHofstra.com.
They'll test you. Try to break your will. But however loud the loudness gets, however many cheese puffs may fly, you're the driver. The one in control. Stand firm. Just wait. And move only when you hear the click that says they're buckled in for the drive. Never give up till they buckle up. Disaster tips from the objects left behind.
My car isn't insured, but you can check your insurance policy now to make sure you're covered.
My savings are lost, but you can put money aside to plan for unexpected disaster costs.
We're lost forever, but you can scan important documents now so they survive.
For more tips on how to prepare, visit ready.gov.
Patriotism. It inspires passionate debate. It's worn like a badge of honor, with good reason. Because it means love and devotion for one's country. But what really makes up this country of ours? It's the people. To love America is to love all Americans. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, sexuality, disability, race, religion, and other labels. Because love has no name.
Projections need to be loved. It's Thursday.
Seriously, Thursday?
This is really
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
I can't do Thursday, but I can do that.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency.
everything is on the line. There's no we'll get them next time. It's win or go home. March Madness is just around the corner. The CAA Women's Basketball Tournament is coming to the University of Delaware March 13th to 16th. 10 teams, one goal, to be crowned champion. Go to caasports.com for more information.
Hi, Meals on Wheels.
I'm Marco. I'm a college student, and I volunteer as a driver for Meals on Wheels.
I think it's awesome meeting these people. I mean, they're so interesting. They've had so many wonderful experiences.
Go Army.com/OOTC, paid for by the U.S. Army.
second half of action here at the David S. Mack Arena on the campus of Hofstra University. And it is 39-37. Hofstra leads after what was a back-and-forth first half, Victoria. I mean, both teams, a little bit of a choppy half of play, but really, I mean, at the end of the day, both teams kind of battling it out. And at the end of that half, especially, just trading buckets and going back and forth.
That last run by the Pride where they defensively stole the ball away from Towson and took it the other way, got it an easy slam jam by Eli Pemberton. You might look back at that as a turning point if they come out with a lot of energy in this second half. Definitely need to be more aggressive offensively, but in a cautious way. I know that might not make a lot of sense, but it seemed like they got into a lot of isolation basketball at certain periods, and that's not when the Pride are at their best. They're at their best when they're passing the ball around, getting that extra look, because they have so many different players capable of hitting the long ball. That's what you want to see if you are the Pride. And defensively, just continue putting pressure on Towson, because holding up 37 points is a pretty decent first half, especially considering there was a point where they had a 7-0 run. And you have to understand that Towson defensively just does things better than certain teams in the CAA, so it's going to be a grind until that buzzer finally sounds off.
And that's why, you know, Hofstra shooting 50% the first time these two teams played was honestly just a shock. I mean, Towson does not let teams shoot the ball well against them, and you see why. They play defense aggressively, and they make you, I guess, uncomfortable would be the best way to describe it. Hofstra defensively was really not, offensively, excuse me, was really not comfortable, as we'll take a look at some first half stats here. So far, obviously, 39-37 Hofstra lead. Towson leading the rebound advantage, 21-15, 10 assists for Hofstra, 6 for Towson. They're the leading scorers for both teams. For Towson, it's Brian Fox with 15. And on the other side for Hofstra, Justin Wright Foreman with 9 in the first half. Again, Wright Foreman coming in on a hot streak. So, I mean, with a few seconds left here before we get into the second half, what is the key to the second half for the Hofstra Pride for them to come out on top?
For the Hofstra Pride, I want to see more aggressiveness on offense, but at the same time, making sure you don't take solo shots early in the shot clock. Drain that shot clock out, drain the clock, and get that perfect look, because they're capable of doing it. And maybe also get the bigs involved some more. And very quiet first half from Taylor and Dwyer. Dwyer played more than Taylor, interestingly enough. To see if that's the matchup that we have to see when it comes off the bench. Will it be Dwyer in the second half, or will it be Taylor? Because the last 12 minutes or so, it was Dan Dwyer getting most of the reps.
And again, Hofstra in their road, in their home whites, excuse me, they will go from left to right. And on the other side for Towson, they're in their road black jerseys. They will be going from right to left here in this second half. Hofstra showing their starting five. And on the other side, it's the starting five for this Towson team as well. Towson ball to start the half. We should mention, Victoria, that today is Hofstra point guard DeShore Bowie's birthday, so happy birthday to DeShore.
I'm sure if you ask DeShore, he just wants a victory for his birthday.
That would be a good birthday present. So here at Towson with the ball. And on the far side, it's Dotton, guarded there by Wright Foreman. Sanders back in the game. We didn't really see him after he got that technical in the first half, as Sanders puts up a shot from the free throw line. No good, rebounded by Taylor. Bowie, the birthday boy, looking to push. Gives it to Wright Foreman. Screen set there by Taylor. Near side of the court, it's DeShore. Going to go inside for Taylor, but he gets the 9. 15 on the shot clock here. And it's Wright Foreman at the logo. Screen set by Taylor. Wright Foreman goes around, and he's fouled. They'll get the reach-in foul there. And looks like they'll get Sanders.
That was the total number 29, Sanders.
So, Hofstra ball underneath the hoop.
And Kenny already in his second half. I like the fact that Bowie didn't like the matchup down low. He kicked it back out. He didn't try and force anything. And that's what Hofstra needs to continue doing.
Inbound to Taylor. Gives it back to Wright Foreman. Baseline 2 is no good, as that one was off the side of the backboard.
Not a good look from Wright Foreman, especially with over 15 seconds on the shot clock, as he claps his hand knowing maybe he shouldn't have taken that shot.
Beatron looking to go inside. It's Fobbs. Free throw line over Taylor. 23 over 23 is good for Brian Fobbs. 39 all. Pemberton now near side. Gives it in the corner to Bowie. Bowie around a screen from Taylor. Goes up top. Far wing 3 from Coburn is no good. Short. And that one's going to be grabbed there by Tunstall. And Fobbs will push it across the timeline. Fobbs, double team there on him. Gives it over to Sanders, but he traveled. So Sanders pivoted at the free throw line there. Looked to make a bounce pass inside, but they're going to get him on the travel.
And after that hot start for Sanders, all of a sudden he got that technical foul, then sat down for the majority of the first half. Not a good start for the big man. 2 minutes into the second half.
Sanders only averages 8.1 points per game, so obviously was a very big first half for him when you consider his averages. Here it's Pemberton on the floor, spins, puts it up with the left hand, off glass and in. Eli Pemberton with the left hand is good.
Pemberton kind of gave a look back down low. Nice aggressive take by Pemberton using his frame to get that size advantage.
And it's almost the same play that Sanders got called for a technical for in that first half, as here a shot from Fobbs is blocked by Taylor, grabbed by Tunstall, but knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Towson. So obviously for Pemberton there, going to have to be careful on that. The referee talking to Pemberton in the middle of the court right now, probably about that same play, because almost a little bit of, you know, a double standard there, as that technical foul was not called on Eli. Underneath the hoop here, it's Dotton looking to get it in on a bounce for Fobbs. Fobbs with 10 on the shot clock, backing down right. Foreman gets into the paint, puts it up with the left hand, no good, rattles out. Rebound skied for by Taylor, but he loses it. Grabbed by Sanders, and he's rejected by Taylor. What a block by Jaquiel. Bowie now across the court, dishes for Taylor, puts it up, slam with the left hand. Jaquiel Taylor throwing it down after a block on the other end. 43-39, Hofstra.
And now the MAC is on its feet. That's exactly what the Pride wanted in the second half, already getting that home court advantage. Nice energy by the Pride.
Fobbs here on the inside, guarded by Wright Foreman. Looks to back down his man. And they're going to get Eli Pemberton on the foul there. Like a blocking foul. Questionable call, but it'll be Towson ball underneath the hoop.
And Taylor with four blocks already. Saw him lose the defensive rebound, but go right back up, not giving up on the play, and hustling back down for the slam.
Dotton underneath the hoop, looking to get it in. He gives it into Fobbs. Fobbs near wing, gives it to Dotton. Dotton dribbles it out to the top of the key. Hofstra again playing that 2-3 zone. Goes around the screen from Sanders, gives it over to Tunstall. Baseline jumper is good. As it's Dennis Tunstall getting his 6th and 7th points of the games. Game, excuse me, 43-41. Only one game being played here.
Last time we checked, just one.
Just one.
One more the merrier.
Bowie, near wing, goes around the screen, gives out now far side. Pemberton, quarter three, no good off front iron. And it's rebounded by Sanders.
Pemberton still trying to find his first three of the game. He's 0-for-5 from beyond the arc in this game.
Dotton at the logo. Gives over on the far side, it's Beatron. Back up top, Dotton gives it inside. Sanders working on his man, Ray, puts it up and is fouled. So two shots coming here for Nakai Sanders.
And Sanders, who we mentioned in that first half, had a tremendous rebounding performance, had 6 rebounds about 5 minutes into the game, then got slowed down with that technical foul. But Sanders coming off a career-high 17 points and 10 boards in the win over Drexel. He's a Staten Island native, so definitely a homecoming for him. And in his time at Staten Island in high school, he was all-time score, 7th all-time, about 1,500 points. He even had an offer from VCU but decided to go to the Quins instead, transferring over to the Towson, one of the 4 transfers on this roster that are trying to still get acquainted with one another and this Towson program at Sanders. Hits that free throw. Sanders, if he stays on this court, can be seen as an X factor for the Tigers.
And Sanders this season shooting 50% from the field, so pretty efficient player down low, and he certainly has been so far tonight as he knocks down that second free throw. 43 all with 16:36 to go here in the second half. It's Bowie across the timeline. Coburn's checked back in for Ray. Jalen Ray's been in a bit of foul trouble during the game. Entry pass here inside as Wright Foreman up and under is good. 45-43. Nice find from the short booth. Howard gives it over far side. It's Beatring up top. Beatring guarded there by Bowie. Screen set by Fobbs, but he takes a long three. That one's no good off back iron. Sanders fighting for the rebound, but it's going to be grabbed by Taylor. Taylor for Bowie. Guarded there by Howard, dishes it now near side. Coburn, right wing three, no good off back iron. He gets his own rebound, and Hofstra will get a new 30. Bowie at the logo, calls out a play. Hofstra leading 45-43. Coburn near side, bounce pass for Wright Foreman in the corner. Wright Foreman, couple jab steps, puts up a three. That one's no good, short, and the rebound is grabbed there by Tunstall. Here it's Howard with the ball. He's been quiet tonight. Just 3 points on 1 of 5 shooting. He's the second leading scorer for this Towson team, coming in at 10.7 points per game. Beatron inside. Fobbs sizing up Jaquiel Taylor. Fobbs puts it on the floor. Spin move inside. Puts it up, and it's good. What a spin move there. He knocked down Taylor. Taylor looking for the foul call. Nothing doing as it's 45 all. On the far corner, it's Bowie. Puts it on the floor. Tries to drive in. And we will get a foul on the floor. 45 all, 15:05 to go here at the MAC. You're listening to all the action as well as watching right here on GoHofstra.com.
Thanks. Please direct your attention to Senator Gordon, Hofstra University Director of Athletics, Rick Cole Jr., along with Assistant Director of Athletics.
This is it. This is the time of year when everything is on the line. There's no we'll get them next time. It's win or go home. March Madness is just around the corner. The CAA Women's Basketball Tournament is coming to the University of Delaware March 13th to the 16th. 10 teams, one goal, to be crowned champion. Go to caasports.com for more information.
This is the fourth time in the world, and you're in your role. And the first team has won the five times. Congratulations on your achievement, and thank you for your outstanding
to go here at the MAC, and it's 45 all between Hofstra and Towson. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway on the call. And Vic, when you look at this second half to the start of the second half, a little bit better for Hofstra. It feels like they've been shooting the ball a little bit more efficiently here in this half. But again, I mean, it's been just a struggle for Hofstra to score points, not what we're used to seeing.
I mean, a little bit better when you look at the stats, 38% compared to when you're shooting below 30 in that first half with some of the points. But Kenny, it just seems like every bucket's been a struggle. The first minute and a half, there's a lot of positive energy from the Pride doing a good job getting in the paint and scoring, but that slowed down. There's been some back and forth, I don't want to say altercations, but a lot of physicality on both sides, something to definitely watch out for because referees have spoken to both sides and we've already seen one technical foul dished out.
Here it's Bowie, top of the key, 20 on the shot clock for Hofstra. Right, Foreman now on the far wing. With the same five on the floor. Justin dribbles it out, goes all the way cross court to Coburn, now near side. Pemberton with eight on the shot clock, puts a move on, step back three. That one's no good. Off iron, and it's rebounded by Fobbs for Towson. Fobbs for Howard, near corner. Looks to drive on Bowie, but he pulls up. Howard dribbles it back out, top of the key at the logo. Here it's McNeil, back for Howard. Screen set there by Fobbs. Now it's Fobbs. Another pick there from Sanders. 10 on the shot clock now for Towson. Fobbs guarded by Bowie. He's got to put a move on. Makes a move. Step back three. Top of the key is good. Brian Fobbs just shooting the lights out here at the MAC as he's now up to 19 points on the day.
And that's what he averages in CAA play, right on target, leading the way for the Tigers. Hofstra has not had an answer for him thus far.
9 of 14 from the field. 4 of 5 from 3 for Fobbs. As here it's Coburn. Top of the key for Bowie. Swinging it near side, it's right for me. Screen set by Taylor. Justin puts a dribble move on top of the key. Three, swish. Justin Wright Foreman now up to 14 points on the day. And I forgot to mention this when he made his last bucket, but 81 consecutive games in double figures for Justin. That's the second longest streak in the country. Here it's Fobbs at the free throw line, guarded by Coburn. Entry pass for Sanders is errant. And Sanders tracks it down. Gives it back up top, it's Howard. Howard guarded by Bowie, screen set by Fobbs. He rolls around it. Shot from three is no good for Howard. He struggled from the field as the rebound is grabbed by Sanders. Sanders all over the offensive glass, his fourth offensive board of the day. Howard gives it back for McNeil. McNeil controls it, top of the key. Gives inside for Tunstall, blocked by Taylor. Oh, Jaquiel Taylor coming across and swatting that one out of there as Pemberton looks to drive the other way, puts it up, and Tunstall answers on the other end with a block of his own against the glass. Teams trading blocks as Towson comes the other way. Far corner three from Howard rattles in. What a turn of events there as Towson comes away with what they're counting as a two-pointer right now. 50-48 Tigers. Bowie rolls around the screen, goes near side. In the corner, it's Coburn for three, rattles out. That's Pemberton, skies in for the rebound, puts it up and is fouled. So Pemberton will get two shots at the line here. And Victoria, something that I remember from the Elon game when I was on site is Eli's shots weren't falling, but he really crashed the glass well in that game. And that's something that he really has done a nice job so far in the opening, you know, half and a half of this game.
And that's something Ryan Connell always points out about him. He calls him a rim crasher, slasher, dasher, however you want to say it, because he always finds a way to get down low. And that's what you have to do, because some nights your shot is just not going to fall. You need to find a way to still contribute to your team. As he misses that free throw, very uncharacteristic of this team, but tonight they've missed quite a few free throws. I mean, Bowie at the line had a technical free throw, missed it. Pemberton now missing three free throws. Something to watch out for as we go down to the end of this matchup. Pride can't hit their free throws. That's definitely going to be something that they're going to be looking back at saying, we had an opportunity. But Pemberton, like you mentioned, great job crashing that board as Coburn missed another three. His shot's just not falling this evening. Still an opportunity, though, for the Pride to come away with points on that possession.
So Fobbs will check out, as well as Sanders. Those have been the two guys that have hurt Hofstra all night. So maybe an opportunity here with those two on the bench to make a bit of a run. As Trueheart comes in as well for Hofstra. Pemberton's free throw is up and good. So 50-49 Tigers with 12:28 to go here in this second half. Howard, top of the key, guarded by Bowie. Thomas is back after being injured and going to the locker room in the first half. It's first time we've seen him since then for Towson. Near side, it's Beatrans, screen set. Chooses not to use it. Pass there deflected by Wright Foreman. Just eight on the shot clock for the Tigers. As the near corner, it's Howard. Howard double team, goes around the screen, puts it on the floor, bounce pass inside, puts it up again, another block by Taylor. Make it six on the day for Jaquiel as Hofstra comes the other way. Long NBA range three for Wright Foreman, no good. Rebound grabbed by Taylor, puts it up and in. Jaquiel Taylor asserting himself at both ends of the floor here. 51-50 Hofstra.
In this second half, he was very quiet in the first half. Not the same story. Already a career high this evening with six blocks.
Bounce pass inside here, up and no good. Foul called on the play. That was Oyelamo. So he will get two free throws. He's got 4 points on the day. And we will step aside. 51-50 Hofstra. 11:31 to go here in the second half. You're listening and watching all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
Take your career to the next level with a graduate degree at Hofstra University. Choose from nationally ranked MBA programs, fully accredited mental health programs, and graduate programs in healthcare, communications, science, counseling, education, and more. Take advantage of flexible class schedules, state-of-the-art campus facilities, online classes, and experiential learning. Learn more at a graduate open house. Visit hofstra.edu/gradTV.
Play here at the MAC, and it's Hofstra leading 51-50 over Towson. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway here on the call. And Victoria, with his most recent bucket, Justin Wright Foreman just made a bit more of Hofstra history for himself.
I mean, in a season where he scored 48, he's got 2,000 career points this season for his career, obviously. It's been a season of accolades for Wright Foreman, but with that bucket, he moves into fifth all-time on Hofstra's all-time scoring list with Rich Laurel. He passes him. He played in 1973 to 1977. And Kenny, I know I mentioned this a little bit earlier, but Justin Wright Foreman averaged maybe 4 minutes a game, under 2 points a game his freshman season, and a lot of players would have left or transferred saying, I didn't get my minutes, I didn't get my looks, I need to go somewhere and develop. He chose to stick around, and I'll never forget the game I believe he took off the Pride. We're playing against Kentucky at Barclays Center. He had about 15 points, he got more playing time, and ever since then, he has been a star. He's been a once-in-a-generation player for this Hofstra Pride program, and he might even get even closer to the tops list, but it's just crazy to think if he was a starter freshman year, he probably would have retired as the all-time Hofstra Pride leading scorer. But I'm sure if you ask Justin, he doesn't care about that. All he wants to do is get that ring, make it to the big dance as the free throw is missed by Towson. It's just been a treat, a gift, whatever you want to say, to be able to watch Ryan Forner perform this season.
And he's certainly just been all over the place. You know, when it comes to national coverage and local coverage, and everyone's really paying attention to Justin Wright Forman. NBA scouts coming out every night. As here, the free throw is missed, but the rebound grabbed by Towson. So they'll get a fresh 30. 51-50 Hofstra with 11:22 to go. Up top, it's Howard dishing it inside Thomas. On a bounce for Fobbs. Puts it up, loses control. And the rebound is grabbed there by Oyelamo, and he puts it up and a foul. So more second and third chance points for Towson. 52-51, they lead.
And I was just about to say, great no call by the referees on the moment before that. He went up to the basket and he lost the handle, so they didn't call it. So great job there by Taylor. But again, he went straight up. So they're going to call a foul on that. Interesting call. It happened in the first half as well, where he had his hand straight up and was called for his first personal foul. But you know, for the Pride, you're lucky because they're Towson right now not hitting their free throws. They've been sent to the line three times in the last minute, have missed all three attempts.
Justin Wright Forman here. With the ball, gives it over for Bowie, 52-51. As here it's JWF giving it over to Taylor. Taylor back for Wright Forman, 10 on the shot clock. Justin puts it on the floor, takes it inside, loses control there on the pass. Looked like he was attempting to kick it out, but it's stolen by Towson.
Fifth turnover of the game for Wright Forman. See the frustration on his face.
Here for Fobbs, inside pass to Oyelamo, who puts it in. So Oyelamo coming in here and making an impact as it's 54-51 Tigers. 10:25 to go. Pemberton with the ball, screen set by Taylor. Ray and Coburn set the check in from for Hofstra, but there is Pemberton traveling on that play.
Hey, Kenny, the Hofstra Pride have to be careful right now to not get into isolation basketball. Something they did back at Northeastern when they weren't hitting their shots. They were just making it into a one-man game. Right now, they still have plenty of time, just a three-point deficit with plenty of time left in this game. Settle down and try to get some open looks.
Howard with the ball. As it's Coburn, Wright Forman, Pemberton, Ray, and Taylor on the floor for Hofstra. Bounce pass here inside Beatrin, and a foul. Another and one opportunity coming here from Towson. And Hofstra really has not had much of an answer here over these last few minutes.
Towson just simply driving to the basket and being stronger as they're taking it up strongly, heading to the free throw line. Now Beltran, you have to wonder, he just has 2 points in this game, but is he going to get going? He's been chirping a lot on the defensive end at Pemberton, at Wright Forman. If he can get going for Towson, Hofstra might be in for a little bit of a long finish to this evening.
Beltran averaging just 4.1 points per game as he puts that one up and in. So 57-51, Towson. Wright Forman with the ball, guarded there by Fobbs as Wright Forman drives inside, kick out, and they're going to get Wright Forman for traveling. So a couple turnovers here in a row by Hofstra. Towson on a 7-0 run over this last minute and 15 seconds or so, and they have really gained some momentum.
Try to turn the ball over three times in the last 2 minutes.
Beatrice, top of the key, gives it to Fobbs. Makes his move inside, dishes back out for Howard. Screen set by Fobbs now. Howard, free throw line, dishes back out. 12 on the shot clock for the Tigers. Driving inside as Fobbs puts it up with the left hand. Nifty finish off glass and in. And we will get timeout for Coach Mihalik. So not a good few minutes here for Hofstra as Townsend now on a 9-0 run. And they lead 59-51.
For the Pride, they started this second half with a lot of energy. They did a great job finding some good open looks, but then all of a sudden, Towson on the defensive end, not allowing them to drive into the paint. Wright Forman on that previous possession, Kenny, they gave him the left side, which is not what you want to do considering he's a lefty. That didn't matter. He was called for a travel, and if Hofstra's going to continue to be sloppy with the ball right now, they only have 8 for the game, 6 of those by Wright Forman. Could be ugly the last 9.5 minutes. And for the Pride, coming off just their second conference loss, you wondered how they'd respond in this matchup. And you also asked about Towson, who currently sits fifth in the CAA. They have a lot that they're playing for, trying to maybe jump ahead of Delaware in the standings. And they're playing like a team that's been on fire of late with the energy. They're jumping off the bench every time a three ball gets knocked in. for the Pride, though. You still have plenty of time. You have to look at it from the standpoint that you have not hit your shot. So if you can start getting your shots to fall like you've done all season, you can jump right back into this game. But you can't allow frustration to take over. You've seen it on Wright Foreman's face. Pemberton as well with some of the non-foul calls. You just have to be patient enough.
And Hofstra now has had three turnovers in their last 2:08, and they are in a scoring drought over that time. So this is a crucial timeout here for Hofstra, and probably a well-timed one from Coach Mihalik, as Hofstra is really going to have to look to kind of get this thing going right now in this second half, because really, as of late, they have certainly struggled, and we will see what they can do here.
Most definitely. 59-51, just an 8-point deficit for the Pride, but when you look at their entire lineup outside of Wright Foreman, Pemberton has 11 points. Colbert with just 2 points. Disappointing performance, I'm sure he would say. He's 0-4 from beyond the arc, 0-5 from the floor. Just 2 rebounds. Even though he looked like he's trying to crash the board, just not had anything go his way. And then for Pemberton, getting to the line 5-for-7, but beyond the arc, he's yet to hit a 3-ball. If he can just hit 1 or 2, that would completely change the momentum in this game, because right now, it seems like Towson's playing like the team that has the home court advantage with a lot of energy.
So 59-51 here coming out of the timeout. After, like we mentioned, struggling here to score over these last few minutes, but a big opportunity to get some points going with 9:30 left in this second half. Wright Foreman goes around a screen from Taylor. Taylor comes back, sets another. JWF for Ray. Jalen's been quiet today, just 5 points, only attempted 2 field goals. Pemberton to the hoop, up and no good. Rebound fought for, it'll go out of bounds, and that one will go to Towson. And that one might have been a questionable call. Taylor's hands were in there, as well as, I believe it was Beatrin, but could have gone either way, a little bit of a 50-50 ball.
Taylor again, though, crashing the boards efficiently for the Pride, just not able to come down with it, even though he's been in the middle of a lot of close contested rebounds.
Top of the key, it's Howard. Howard guarded there by Pemberton. Bounce pass inside for Thomas. Guarded there by Taylor. Thomas looks to back down his man. Goes up with the right hand. That one rolls in. Alex Thomas getting on the board here with his first points of the night after getting injured in the first half. 61-51, Towson with the lead. 11-0 run for the Tigers as Wright Foreman puts up a three here. No good. Rebounded by Towson. Coburn comes back here, makes a steal. Wright Foreman saves it, keeps it in bounds. Great hustle play by Justin. See if that gets some momentum for the Pride. Ray in transition for three. It's good. Big three from Jalen Ray. 61-54 with 8:15 to go.
If the Pride ever needed a clutch three bucket, it was right there. Big play by Jalen Ray, but it was started by Wright Foreman not giving up on the ball.
First Hofstra points in over 3 minutes. Crowd on their feet here at the MAC, chanting defense. Here it's inside. Oyelamo again giving Hofstra trouble. He went right around Taylor and flushed it home with two hands. 63-54 now, Towson.
And Taylor just got beat right there on the baseline. He turned around looking for help, but that was a simple mismatch.
Ray pulls up from the free throw line. Short rebound grab there off front iron by Taylor. Pemberton near wing. Bounce pass inside. Shaquille backing down his man. Dishes back out for Pemberton. Eli down low off the hands of Thomas and out of bounds. And we will step aside. 63-54. Towson on a 13-3 run here at the MAC. We'll see how it finishes up. You're listening to all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
All right, fans, please welcome back yours.
It's time to register for Saturday classes for young people. Hofstra Continuing Education offers a variety of programs for your child. Students can get help in math, reading, and writing. Like video games and coding, we have you covered. Enjoy the arts? Check out cartooning, theater, and studio arts, sports classes, swimming, and more. Take your child's education to the next level with science, pre-collegiate, and gifted programs. Register today online or call 516-463-7400.
Towson, the sixth place seed in the CAA, over Hofstra, the CAA leaders. Kenny Conner out of Victoria, Conway on the call. And Victoria, over this last like 4 or 5 minutes, it's just been all Tigers.
100%. Towson's playing like they have the home court advantage. They have the energy. And quite frankly, Hofstra seems frustrated and defeated when there's 10 minutes, now 7.5 minutes left. But you have to keep your head up if you're the Pride. You know you can score in bunches. Granted, Towson has a tremendous defense. That should slow you down when you're thinking right now. They need to stay focused if they want to flip the script of this game, because Townsend is getting in their heads. They're playing more aggressively, getting those big stops. And for Hofstra, a big time possession right now out of the timeout to try to continue chipping back into this deficit.
So a 13-3 run here for Townsend. Hofstra with the inbound. Ray, near corner three. That's good. Jalen Ray with back-to-back threes. 63-57 Tigers.
The sixth man off the bench. A spark plug right there for the Pride, coming up clutch right now.
It's Dotton, top of the key. Gives up top. Beatrick, near side, or far side, excuse me. That's Oyelamo, who has just been toasting Hofstra here in the second half. Another bucket for him. Came in averaging 4.7 points per game. And he's got 10 here in the second half. Ray up top for Pemberton. Gives it to Coburn, far side. Eli at the top of the key, gives it to Justin. All right, Foreman, around the screen, dish inside. Nice find for Taylor, and he's fouled on the way up. So two free throws coming for Jaquiel here. Nice find there by Hofstra. Again, they've had trouble penetrating that Towson defense, but it's going to take entry passes like that to be able to break this Towson D.
And let's be honest, Towson knows Hofstra likes to shoot the three ball, so they're going to try and stop them from doing that. Great job by Wright Foreman driving and once again making that extra pass as Taylor knocks down his 10th point of the game. Another double-double for Jaquiel Taylor, coming on strong in this late stretch for the Hofstra Pride. Let's see if it's enough, though, to push them across as they're still down by 7.
And Taylor's been a monster so far in this game as far as block shots go, with 6 already, as we get Bowie checking in. And Hofstra seems like, over the last few minutes, their defense has almost suffered as a result of their frustration on offense, too. I think that all of a sudden, Townsend's been getting easy baskets, which they really weren't in the early going of this game. So we'll see if Hofstra can kind of tighten that up on the defensive end. Beatrend here across half court, guarded by Wright Foreman. 6:45 to go, 65-59. It's Towson leading. Dotton at the top of the key. Dishes off for Beatrend. Now it's Fobbs. Fobbs with 5 on the shot clock. Has to make a move. Takes an NBA range 3. No good off back iron. Rebounded by Wright Foreman. First rebound of the day for Justin. Right, Foreman around the screen from Taylor. Nice move inside. And the Euro step is good off glass and in. 65-61. As Hofstra's crept back in a bit here. And a timeout for Townsend's head coach.
And right there, Kenny, great job by Wright Foreman pretending like he was going to shoot the three ball, taking it to the right side. And that's what you need to do if you're Wright Foreman. Beautiful hesitation move, as you can see on the replay, finishing strongly. And Towson had no answer for it. But Kenny, it goes back to that previous possession. What did they do defensively? They made Fobbs throw up a crazy three with about 2 seconds left on the shot clock because they were disciplined. They did not allow their frustrations from the offensive side to get into their mindset defensively, because the last couple of possessions, Towson was just walking to the basket. It was kind of a joke. Hofstra was not playing disciplined defense, but right now, flipping that script, getting the ball back, going the other way. And if you can get Ryan Foreman going, he's got 16 points. Not his best shooting performance from beyond the arc. 33% is still solid, but you know Ryan Foreman shooting closer to 40% on the season. You can get him going late. We've seen it time and time again. He can close out a game and overcome the Towson Tigers.
6:15 to play, 65-61 Tigers. Here it's Dotton taking it across the half-court line for Logo. Defense chance raining out here at the mat. Dotton, top of the key, guarded by Bowie. 6 minutes left, 14 on the shot clock. Pass inside, Sanders, stolen away by Bowie, good hands. As Bowie looks to push it across to Shore, dishes back for Justin, NBA range 3. He got it! Justin Wright Foreman with a huge 3. The Hofstra bench is pumped up. That was a deep one. 65-64 now Townsend. 7-0 run for Hofstra. Here it's Dotton. Bounce with the ball, gives it to Dotton now. Crowd coming alive here at the MAC. Dotton, spin move, no good, off front iron. Hofstra with an opportunity to take the lead. It's Wright Foreman in transition. Puts a move behind the MAC on Dotton, but he lost the ball. Too quick there from Justin. Dotton now looking to push it the other way. Puts it on the floor, up inside, no good. Rebound grabbed by Fobbs, puts it up and he's fouled. Shot no good, he'll go to the line for two shots.
And that previous possession, Kenny, that was Roy Foreman getting a little too anxious. Of course, you feel the crowd coming back. He just drained to Zeke the rebound. Probably just pulled back the reins and set up a play. Nonetheless, though, still only down 1 point. And Fobbs right there, though, once again, in the middle of it, 24 points for Fobbs in his New York homecoming. I have to give him credit. He's done it all for the Towson Tigers, shooting 10 of 16 from the floor. Good for the best percentage on the team so far from downtown. He's 4 of 6 as he makes that free throw to make it a two-point game. But Kenny, down the stretch, Hofstra offensively, it'll be interesting to see if they make some set plays where they continue to try and push the tempo like they've done in the last couple of possessions.
Most points Fobbs has scored in a game this season is 32. It came against UMBC, so potentially an opportunity here to break that in this game. He's had a very nice day for Towson. Second free throw is no good off front iron. 66-64 Towson. 5:05 to play. That's right, Foreman at the logo. Justin calls out a play. Taylor sets a screen. And right, Foreman goes cross court. Near corner three for Bowie. Short. No good, and it's rebounded by the Tigers. Dotton with the ball, controls, gives it now to Fox. Allen on the near wing, gives inside for Thomas. Thomas looking to back down Taylor. Taylor goes for the steal, and that one will go out of bounds. Taylor never touched it. Good aggressive play by the Hofstra big, as this one will go back to the Pride.
And it was a smart play. He knew when to take a chance right now, just down to stealing the possession in that moment. Huge play by Taylor. It's a gamble, the one that paid off for Jaquiel Taylor.
Taylor always so patient defensively on those back downs. Probably didn't expect that one coming, did Thomas. Here it's right Foreman. 4:25 to go in the game. Towson leads by two. Justin inside for Jaquiel. Looks to put it up. Gets it up. Ah, no good as that one rolls off the rim. And it'll be two shots coming for Jaquiel Taylor.
He almost had an one opportunity. Very close to finishing. But nonetheless, again, right Foreman looking like he's going to shoot and passing it down low. Become more of a facilitator in this ball game, but it's great to see he has the capabilities to pass the ball and find the open man. Taylor now at the line with two huge free throws.
So two shots coming from Jaquiel as he puts the first one up, no good off front iron. Hofstra, you mentioned it earlier, Victoria, but not the best day free throw shooting for them. 74% now, which, I mean, it's a pretty solid day. It's a lot better than Towson's 56%, but for this Hofstra team, they typically shoot in the 80s somewhere, so not the best day at the line for the Pride.
And in a game where every point counts, obviously you look back to that as something as a key point moving forward, as Taylor does knock down that one, making a one-point deficit.
Big defensive possession here from Hofstra. They have not had the lead since there was 11 minutes and 41 seconds left in this second half. Here it's Dotton, far side, guarded by right Foreman. Screen set by Oyelamo. Dotton goes inside, puts it up with the left hand. He is fouled by Taylor. Shot's no good. And to get two free throws coming from Dotton.
And Dotton trying to get on the score sheet for the first time this evening. He's 0 for 5. His first trip to the free throw line. You mentioned the Towson Tigers just shooting 56% on the season. Right there, close play. Taylor looked like almost a little over aggressive on that play. His third personal foul. Dotton misses that free throw.
No good there from Dotton. He is really struggling. You mentioned Victoria from the field today. Comes in shooting 41%, but obviously 0%, well below that. And both teams really in the second half here, it's been a bit of a struggle to score, and it's just kind of been a very methodical back and forth game. And both teams playing strong defense. Dotton's second free throw is no good. He just can't buy a bucket as Pemberton grabs a rebound. 4 minutes to play, 66-65 Tigers. Bowie comes around a screen from Taylor. Gives to Pemberton. Pemberton for Ray. NBA range three. That one no good. It's short. Rebound skied for by Taylor. Taylor dish out for right Foreman. Near side. New 30 for the Pride. Here it's Bowie. Top of the key. Back for Justin. Justin for Eli. Pemberton puts it on the floor. Drives inside. Puts it up with the right hand. No good. No foul called. And the rebound's grabbed there by Tunstall.
A little too strong there by Pemberton, but I like the aggressive take trying to get a high percentage shot.
Dotton with the ball, 3:25 to go. Howard at the logo, gives to Dotton, far side, 15 on the shot clock, guarded by right Foreman. Thomas comes up top. Dotton doesn't use the screen. Goes around right forward, puts it up inside right hand. Bank shot is good. So Dotton finally gets a shot to go. 68-65, Towson.
And that was a tough shot to knock down, but he found the square off the bank and in. Big possession up coming for the Pride.
Bowie for Wright Foreman, far side. Taylor comes up top, sets a screen. Wright Foreman double teamed, and we're going to get a kickball call there. As the official underneath called the kickball, not the one that was right next to the play. Interesting call, but we will take a timeout. 68-65 Tigers, 2:56 to go here in the second half. We'll see all the action right here on GoHofstra.com.
Be sure to bring your seats on Saturday by 3:50 for the senior ceremony.
Today, I'm going to show you how to team with your home. First step, hide or keep. Try to be somewhere they would never look. Challenges will come up. Be ready for them. I'm ready for them all. You don't use mannequins or mannequin
challenges. You don't have to know it all to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will be just the same.
Play here in the second half, 68-65, Tigers lead. Kenny Conrad and Victoria Conway here on the call from the David S. Mack Arena. And Victoria, another game here for the Mack that's coming down to the wire. And really, over these last few minutes, Hofstra kind of struggling to score again. No field goals over their last 2:52, but they've been getting to the line and playing very solid defense.
After Wright Foreman hit that big NBA range three ball, you thought that might be the momentum shift that the Pride would need, but nonetheless, Towson doing a good job maintaining their composure as the Hofstra was cutting this lead to just 1 point. They're back out to a three-point lead under 3 minutes to go. And if you're Towson, with your defense, this is the type of game you want. You want to be able to control your own destiny, per se, knowing if you get a few more stops, you're going to escape Hempstead with the victory.
And that's something that's huge right now, is that Towson knows that this is a huge game for them, you know, to go on the road, especially heading into CAA tournament play. So you know they're going to put everything out on the floor, as is Hofstra here. So a big final 2:56 here set up for us at the MAC. As again, it's Towson leading by three. Hofstra ball, far side of the court. It'll be Pemberton looking to inbound. Quite the battle here between these two CAA foes. It's Wright Foreman, NBA range three near wing. That one rattles in. Justin Wright Foreman, sometimes you're good, sometimes you're lucky. He gets the lucky roll there, and it's 68 all.
And he put his hands up like, I don't know how that went in, but I'm going to take it, and yes you will, as it ties the game.
Bowie, top of the key, guarding Dot. Crowd chanting defense here. As it's Fobbs. Fobbs guarded by Bowie. Comes around a screen, heads to the hoop, puts it up, blocked by the rim. That one will go out of bounds. And it'll stay with Towson. Not in love with that call.
And neither is head coach Joe Mahalik. Obviously a huge possession right there. It looked like Ryan were about to get the ball going the other way. But Kenny, I have to say, I think the officials got it right. It looked like it hit off the hands of Pemberton.
Howard will inbound as he gets this one in. It's Tunstall with the ball. 28 seconds left on the shot clock. And the defense chant rings out from the crowd here at the MAC. 2:12, 20 on the shot clock. Dotton passing it inside for Howard, puts it up, and that one's good. Wright Foreman got beat there to the hoop. So the righty shot off glass and in, 70-68 Towson. Bowie for Ray. Ray drills it up top, gives it to Pemberton. Pemberton back for Bowie. Bowie makes a move, takes a long two, and it's good. They will call that one a two, as it looked like his foot was on the line. So we are 70 all. Timeout called here. So 70 all, 1:49 to play.
Clutch bucket right there by Bowie. The step back dribble, and he's had a quiet game, just 9 points. Does have 7 assists, though. A big clutch bucket there by the birthday boy. And right now, Kenny, in these final 2 minutes, you have to wonder, right, Foreman, he's maybe catching fire of late. He's got to be your go-to man if you're drawing up a play in the huddle. Doesn't matter if he's 0-21 in this game. You know he is your best player. And Towson knows that too, though, at the same time. So it'll be up to Wright Foreman to know if he has to pass out of a certain situation if he gets double teamed around the arc, especially as he's bringing up the ball. And on the other side, Towson, you wonder who their go-to is. Father's having a great game, but of late, Dotton's been trying to drive, take the ball to the basket. Sanders does a great job with 12 points. Very interesting matchups that both head coaches need to think about with under 2 minutes to play.
So Hofstra took the timeout. Towson has two timeouts left here in the half, and it's Hofstra with one. And Towson is in the bonus. So they will shoot 3-1-1 at the moment every time they get fouled. For Hofstra, they are not yet in the bonus territory. 70 all. Good finish here at the mat. Hope you're ready. Inbound here for Howard. Tigers looking to push it across. It's Bowie guarding the guys as they come up the court. Howard at the logo, dishes down near side for Fox. Bob stolen by Bowie. Big steal by the point guard. He drives inside, goes up, and he's fouled. So the birthday boy with a big steal there. And he takes that one inside. He'll get two free throws.
We average 4 steals a game in this one. He has 3 now, right on pace with his average. And Bowie always quietly, especially defensively, very lanky guard, and does a great job right there. The perfect opportunity, taking a chance and succeeding.
So Bowie will get 2 free throws. And the last time these two teams played, Bowie actually had a career high in steals with 6. So a light game by his standards here against Towson as he knocks down that first free throw. But I said it earlier, Bowie always comes through with those defensive plays when you least expect it. As he makes that second free throw. So two big heady plays by Hofstra. The steal by Taylor on the other end, as well as that Bowie steal, going to probably loom large in this game if Hofstra's able to hold on. 72-70, 1:25 to go here in the second half. Howard with the ball in the logo. Gives it to Fox, back up top for Howard. Howard around the screen, puts it up for 3. No good off the iron. Rebound grabbed by Sanders, who goes back up and puts it in. Big rebound by Sanders over Taylor. And we will get a timeout by Towson. So one timeout remaining for each side. And another great second chance bucket there from Sanders.
And Sanders did a great job getting that rebound. But Kenny, I'd love to see the replay to see if he went over the back of Jalen Ray. That's what head coach Joe Mahalik was discussing with the official right now. It was very close because it seemed like Ray had the correct positioning. He was in front of Sanders. Nonetheless, no foul called. And like you said, Kenny, you want a close matchup here against the Pride and Towson. You got one. 72 all. Definitely a change of pace from when the last time these two teams faced off. Have to give Towson a lot of credit for continuing with that same fire that they had in the first half, even when it seemed like Hofstra had more energy in the second half. Towson stuck around and went on a big run. Now they're trying to maintain their composure because Hofstra is in the middle of their own
game. Right, Foreman leading Hofstra in scoring this game with 22, and it's Bob's leading all scorers in the game with 25. He's been quiet, no points since about the 6-minute mark of this second half. It's Hofstra here with a 72-70 lead. If you want to know how close this game has been, Hofstra's largest lead was 4, and as for Towson, it was 10, and that came at one of the earlier points in this second half. So really, it's been a back-and-forth battle throughout the game between these two teams. Really defense first, makes it sloppy offense, I would say, but both teams really leaving it all on the court tonight.
And all 5 starters for the Pride in double figures. Normally when you hear that, it means Hofstra has a lead by a lot. That's only when they find their most success. But you have to give the Tigers a lot of credit. Outside of Fox and Sanders, not much doing, but they've had some chirpy plays, especially from Dotton. 7 assists under the radar and 9 rebounds from Tunsall. A lot of unsung heroes from both sides.
Hofstra ball, Bowie for Ray. 72 all, minute 4 to play. Bowie around a screen from Justin. Tries to drive inside, falls as he goes down. Ball on the floor being fought for, and it's come away with by Towson. Big steal there as Hofstra commits a costly turnover there on the Bowie steal. So it's Dotton over the court. 48 on the game clock, 19 on the shot clock. Beatrick going inside for Fobbs. Ray guarding him there. Free throw line extended. Fobbs driving inside, puts it up, and they're going to call a jump ball. The possession arrow will go Hofstra's way regardless. So possession coming here for the Pride. 40 on the game clock, 30 on the shot clock.
Hofstra wanted to travel there, but fortunately the possession arrow was in their favor. Very close play to the officials, and now they're trying to get some clarification. Ball still Hofstra. That's what we know right now.
And it will be be Bowie underneath the hoop inbounding. Again, 72 all here on the mat. Huge possession of Hofstra for Hofstra. 35 on the game clock, 25 on the shot clock. It's Ray. Ray for Bowie. Gives back to Wright Foreman. Shot clock will be turned off after this possession. Wright Foreman looking to make a move. 14 on the shot clock. Wright Foreman around the screen from Taylor. Loses the ball in traffic. Gets kicked out of bounds. Two Towson bodies hit the floor. It's Hofstra ball now. 20 on the game clock and 10 on the shot clock.
Very fortunate for the Pride that it went off of the Towson Tigers because they were close to making Wright Foreman commit his eighth turnover of the game. Nonetheless, Hofstra now has a moment to draw the play and get the shot that they want. 10-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. Huge, huge possession nonetheless for the Pride. After 100 is going to get the ball. My money on Justin.
And the officials here huddled at the scoreboard would think they're probably looking at the play to see who it went off of, but it looked pretty clearly to be off of Towson. Maybe also could be checking the clock at this point in the game. So 20 seconds to go in connection to Victoria. Half the figure, and you'll get a shot here from Justin Wright Foreman. Eight other clutch guys on Hofstra. Jalen Rayola seems to come up with a big shot. So we will see what Coach Joe Mahalik draws up. The officials have broken from the score table, and they are going to say Hofstra ball underneath the wrong hoop. Coming out of the timeout, it's Beatrin Dotton Sanders, as well as Fobbs and Tunstall for Townsend. And on the other side for Hofstra, it's Taylor, Louie, Ray, Wright Foreman, and Pemberton. Bowie will inbound from underneath the hoop with 20 to play. Bowie looking for someone to get it into. Ray, near side, fadeaway three from the corner. No good, that short rebound fought for, grabbed by Fobbs. Shot clock turned off. 12 seconds on the game clock here at the MAC. Final possession here goes to Towson, and we will get a timeout called by the Tigers. So with 9.4 seconds to go, 72 all, it's going to come down to a defensive stop for Hofstra to send this game to overtime.
Their leading scorer is Fobbs with 25. We'll see if the play is drawn up for him. 9.4 on the game clock. Shot clock turned off. It's Dotton, top of the key. Goes around the screen. Dotton looking to go inside. Free throw line jumper. No good off the mark. Taylor with the rebound. 1 second left. Pemberton, three quarters heave is no good off the top of the backboard. Trying to channel a little JMU magic there with Eli Pemberton. But that one no good, and we will get 72 all headed to overtime.
Been really the story all day. They've had times where they've looked solid offensively, like the Hofstra we know, and then there's been other times where Towson's been able to trip them up, and they played really well. And that, you're right, I mean, that last overtime game against Linda Berry was unbelievable. I mean, three overtimes back and forth, and that's something that Hofstra showed throughout the season, is that they just don't want to say die. You know, they're going to come out and they're going to play hard no matter what. Even if the shots aren't falling, they'll give you good defense. If the shots are falling, you know, it's just been, they found ways to win, and that's something that head coach Joe Mahalik talked about, particularly during their extended winning streak in the beginning of the year, or in the beginning of conference play, really, was that this team
looks for ways to win. When you're a team that, you know, loses or doesn't play well, you look for ways to lose. You feel like, you know, the team's making a comeback. And that's something that was the reason they were able to win at William & Mary. It was the reason they were able to come back and win against Northeastern on that Justin Bryant Golden Buzzer Beater. That's just been something that's allowed them to be so successful this season.
I mean, a lot is on the line for the Prime. They have 17 straight victories here at the MAC, dating back to last season, trying to cap off a perfect 2018-2019 campaign here at the MAC. These final 5 minutes determine a lot, and if you see Northeastern still in the lead in their game, Charleston was also leading. Huge implications for the standing. Hofstra, as great as it has been, as great as first place has been, still have to finish out. Still got 3 games in battle for left.
Save five for Hofstra on the court as the tip is won by Towson. Towson going right to left here in the overtime. Black jerseys with yellow trim. Hofstra in the home whites. They'll go from left to right. Here it's Dot sending it in the far corner for Turnstone. Up top here it's Milt shot, no good. Rebound grabbed out of the air there by Sanders. Some more second chance points there off the miss from Fobbs. And it's 74-72 Tigers. Screen set by Ray for Bowie. Now Taylor comes up top, sets the screen on Fobbs. Here it's Wright Foreman. Near corner as that one's knocked out of his hands, out of bounds. Retain possession here right in front of the scorer's table.
And even though he struggled offensively, nice defensive possession right there up on Wright Foreman.
Wright Foreman inbound here for Pemberton. Wright Foreman, NBA range three again on the way, rattles in and out. Pemberton skies it for the rebound. And it's knocked out of his hands, out of bounds off of Pemberton. So it'll go to Towson.
Hofstra again with their shooting percentage falling about 30% from beyond the arc and just 77% from the line. Who tried to get a steal right there. Have to try to get some shots to fall in the final 2 minutes.
Far side here, it's Dunn up top for Beatrick. Trent guarded there by Bowie. Screen set by Fox. By Ray. Inside, it's Fobbs on a dribble, puts it up and in. Strong power move to the basket between two defenders from Fobbs. And the first 4 points of overtime belong to Towson, 76-74. 72, excuse me. Up top, Wright Foreman. Lost the ball, taken away. Steal there by Dotton. Here it's Beatrim with the ball, going up top, and no good, not finished by Turnstone, but he gets his own rebound and puts it back. 78-72 now. Couple turnovers here have really hurt them. Justin Wright Foreman with 8 in the game so far. Wright Foreman out of there, gives it over to Ray. 14 on the shot clock for Hofstra, 3:12 in the overtime. Ray, top of the key for three, it's good. Sweet stroke from Jalen Ray. First points of overtime for Hofstra, now 78-75.
Another clutch bucket by Ray, getting the opportunity to start here in overtime.
Wright Foreman guarding Beatrice. Up top, it's Fobbs. Screen set by Sanders. Fobbs going inside, puts it up. Fancy move with the left hand is good off glass and in. 80-75, 5-point lead for the Tigers with 2:40 to go here in overtime. Ray with the ball on the far side. Gives it back for Bowie in the corner. Bowie puts it on the floor, looks to drive. Bounce pass, near corner, right Foreman three. No good, it's long. Rebound is grabbed, saved by Taylor. Great hustle play going out of bounds. Bowie now, top of the key for three. It's good! The Jaquiel Taylor save, setting up the Bowie three. 80-78 now, Hofstra just trailing by two.
Great hustle play there by Taylor, and Bowie once again coming on strong of late. Some big shots down the stretch.
Dotted across the timeline, 2:05 to go. Defense is the chant from the crowd here at the MAC. Dotton guarded by Bowie. Gives it over for Fobbs. Sanders looks to move inside on Taylor. Fobbs guarded by Wright Foreman. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Step back from the free throw line. No good, short. Rebound grab there by Beatran. Another offensive board for Towson. And 17 offensive boards so far today from the Tigers. Top of the key, it's Beatran. Now going far side. As that's Dotton. Screen set by Saunders, walks away. Up top, Dotton puts it on the floor, looks to drive inside, blocked by Taylor.
Seventh block of the day, and it's a big one. Pemberton saves it off the leg of Dotton and out of bounds. So a huge turnover there, all off great hustle plays from this Hofstra Pride team.
Taylor, with a career evening, he's been on the end of everything positive in this overtime for the Pride.
Bowie across the timeline. Guarded there by Fobbs. Taylor fakes a screen, goes down low, sets it for Wright Foreman, who comes up. Sets a screen for Bowie. On the floor, inside, that one is up. And the shot is going to be good, but they're going to call the foul on the floor there, as it was Sanders who set the screen, set the pick, excuse me, for the charge, and he was hit hard. He hit the floor hard as he will get up. So they will retain possession here for Hofstra.
You can see right here on the replay, had a perfect dish to Taylor, and Sanders thought he maybe drew the charge, but nonetheless, blocking foul send Bowie to the line with an opportunity for the Pride.
Hofstra is in the bonus now, so a one-and-one opportunity coming here for DeShore. We'll see if Sanders stays in the game. Looks like he will check out as Oyelowo will come in. And he was a force earlier in this second half.
And Bowie, if you want somebody at the free throw line, Kenny, with an opportunity with a one-and-one chance, it's Bowie, their best free throw percentage shooter. He was at one point tops in the CAA. He's now second percentage-wise, just having a great year from the charity stripe.
Looked like Sanders may have had his feet set there, but when looking at the replay, it seemed like he slid at the last second into Bowie, and that's what the official called, as Bowie sinks the first half in a 1-1. 80-79 now. Bowie up to 15 on the day. He is 4 of 7 from the field. Strong day from DeShore Bowie. Big factor for overtime was his steal late in regulation. As that one's up and good. 80-all, 108 to play here from the mat. We are in overtime between Hofstra and Towson. Dotton with the ball, gives it far side, it's Howard. Back for Dotton, guarded by Wright Foreman. Now swings it near side. Turns still up top. Now it's Fobbs, sizes up the defender, puts it up, shot's no good, off to the right, and out. Rebound controlled by Hofstra, Wright Foreman's got it. He slows things down. Now up to the logo and across half court. 20 on the shot clock, 35 on the game clock. This will likely be the final possession here of overtime for Hofstra. Wright Foreman around the Taylor screen, drives inside against Dotton, puts it up and in. Justin Wright Foreman with a big shot. 82-80 Hofstra now with 27.5 to go here in the overtime.
Hey, Kenny,
game is going. Justin's 9 of 19. He has 8 turnovers. It's not his best game, but you know what? He's going to find a way to make that big shot in the game, impact the game in some way, and that could have been it. So it would be one final possession likely here for Towson. Hofstra winning by 2 at 27.5. Same five as well on the court for Towson. 20 on the game clock. It's Tunsil. Rolling the ball. Tunsil now sending it over for Howard. 14 on the game clock. Howard puts it on the floor, drives inside. Dish inside. Up with the right hand. It's good. It's Oyelowo who toasted Hofstra in the second half, coming up with that big layup underneath. So with 9.1 seconds to play, Hofstra will have the opportunity to win it.
Surprised that Howard took it to the basket so early in the final 27 seconds. I thought maybe he had to wind it down, make sure it was the final shot of overtime. Nonetheless, we thought maybe we saw the last offensive possession for the Pride. No. 9 seconds to go. They would draw play in the huddle. They're going to have to take a short and catch it right now for the Pride. Pat Ruff likes shooting. I think their best bet is trying to drive it to the basket. He was first to count it. Found it. Finished strong with your layup. Nonetheless, the Pride with the opportunity to win it here. At the Mavericks, they've won several times, 17 times in a row, trying to keep that.
just been back and forth here in overtime. Towson started the overtime hot. It took a six-point lead on Hofstra at one point, but Hofstra has now scored 10 of the last 14 points here in this overtime, 82 all, and Hofstra will have to go the length of the court with it. Just one man in the backcourt for Towson. It's Dotton as they let him clean inbound to Ray. Ray across the timeline with 5 seconds for Bowie. Bowie puts it on the floor, looks to drive inside, puts it up, no foul called. Ball will go out of bounds and stay with Hofstra. And they're going to ask for a replay here from the officials as they will head straight to the monitor, it looks like, to review that one.
And Bowie was met by 3,000 defenders and thought, okay, for sure he's either going to get fouled, he's going to be able to find a way to kick it back out. Nonetheless, great job by the Towson Tigers, as we can see on the replay right now. Whose hand it went off of? Very close. It looks like it went off of Jaquiel Taylor on that replay. 1.4 seconds left. Big change of events if that stands.
And the call on the court was that it'll stay with Hofstra, but I really think after looking at that replay, it was last touched by Jaquiel Taylor. Now, well, we'll wait for the official call from the refs, but it looked like after that replay, it'll be Towson ball. So with 1.4 seconds to go, they'll have it underneath the hoop with likely an opportunity for maybe a half-court shot if they're lucky. Not much time to run the floor right now if you're this Towson team. Go to Towson. So with 1.4 seconds to go, Hofstra loses that possession. Seemed like they might have an opportunity for a buzzer beater, but we will get one final play here. Hofstra puts the same five out of the court, same five as well here for Towson. Underneath the hoop, it's Dotton to inbound with 1.4 on the clock. Again, tie game in overtime here at the MAC. Dotton gonna look to throw a baseball pass full length of the court. He gets it in. Pass up top, deflected, Tunstall going to keep it up with the horn, and that one's wide right. No good.
No foul was called on that play, as both players were the ball, very close play. And then I want to know if underneath the basket, Bond was moving his feet, was not allowed. Very close play there. I put my eyes on the player on the left side of the court. The referee was on the left side trying to get
the same here. And if you're allowed to run the length of the baseline, as far as I know, on those uncontested inbounds. But if we see the replay, it looked like, I think what they were arguing was that when he threw the inbounds pass in, he stepped over the baseline, and that may have been what everyone was arguing about. We had a whole section of fans here behind the Hofstra bench really asking and now booing the official for missing that call. It looked like he might have stepped over, so a little bit of a missed call there, and that would have been a huge play in the game because it would have given Hofstra the ball underneath their own hoop. But nonetheless, this one will stay with the prime.
And we're off another 5 minutes to prove that they can come out victorious against the Towson Tigers, who have not gone away easily. And it seems like Hofstra about to get that momentum back on their feet. And all of a sudden, Towson put it in with another gear that they can stand on by the prime. And that final play, 2 seconds here for the miracle pass. Hofstra did a great job protecting it. And you are supposed to marry him. Game the night got before he when they shot it from the
And the day after a practice, that was something that Coach said they worked on. They focused on that, and he said, you know, he took a lot of the blame for it because he said, if I haven't prepared you for that play, that's my fault. And that's what he felt like happened on that 8-3-pointer. So they're obviously defended very well. It looked like, if I remember correctly, Pemberton and Taylor in the mix defending Tunstall when he got that at half court. So why not do it again? A little more bonus basketball here at the MAC. Second overtime between these two teams. Same five for Hofstra. Same five for Towson as we will tip it up and get going. Again, the tip is won by the Tigers. It'll be Dotton all the way from his own backcourt. Taking it across the timeline for Petrie. Loaded by
Young right Foreman here on the near side. Up top for Dotton. Dotton now looking for someone to pass it to. On a bounce inside. It's Oyelamo. Oyelamo looks to move on Taylor. And they're going to call him on a charge. Oyelamo threw the forearm as he was going to the hoop on Taylor. And we will get positive possession here with 4:35 to go into second overtime.
And again, Nicole Taylor getting involved early in this double OT. We saw him in the first overtime get a hustle pass to Bowie. That was a crucial three-pointer. Nice play there by Taylor again.
Bowie over the timeline gives it to Ray. Now for Bowie. Bowie back for right Foreman. Right Foreman for Ray. Cycling it around. Great. Bounce pass inside. Taylor up with the left hand. Off glass and in. 84-82 Hofstra wins.
Beautiful feed there by Jalen Ray, who's had the hot hand shooting wise. Perfect bounce pass down low to the big man.
Featured guarded by Red Foreman. Now up top for Dotton. Dotton guarded by Bowie. Dotton up top. Gives it to Ray. Low yellow ball on the far side. Shots up. No good. It's short. Rebounded by Ray. Looks to push it across here. It's Bowie as they slow things down. Pride lead by two, 84-82 with 3:50 to go here in double overtime. Now it's Ray, top of the key for Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman puts it on a bounce, goes inside. Nice dish to Taylor, and one. But they will actually call the foul on the floor there as it was a push on Taylor. We'll get a one and one here for Hofstra.
Driving to the basket, but Taylor, who had a defender behind him, still able to get that clear entry pass. Big shots upcoming for Taylor. He transfers right through the shots, might not be falling at the rate he's accustomed to, still being efficient offensively for Pride.
So they called a push there on Tunstall as Taylor went up for the shot. They said he was pushed from the back as Taylor's first free throw short, no good. And rebounded by Dotton. 84-82 Hofstra, 3:38 to play in OT2. Dotton gives it up for Fobbs. Let's go far side now. It's Dotton putting it on the floor, taking it inside on Ray. Spin move, pushes out. Fobbs, 9 on the shot clock here, 3:20 on the game clock in double OT. Fobbs looking to shoot here over Pemberton. 3 on the shot clock. Dotton gonna have to force it up. And that one is no good off back iron. Shaquille Taylor skies for the board. Taylor now up to 17 rebounds on the day. That matches a career high. Justin Wright Foreman inside. Long two is good. Justin Wright Foreman with the dribble move and the 15-footer. 86-82. Just 4 points for Hofstra. None for Towson here. Over 2 minutes into double overtime. Beatrick, top of the key. Gives it over to Dotton. Back up top now, Dotton again, guarded by Bowie. They look to put on the floor. Free throw line jumper, no good, too long. Rebound, fought for in the air, grabbed by Pemberton. Huge rebound for Hofstra on the defensive end. Bowie across the timeline. Hofstra looking to push this lead. This is their largest lead of the game, just 4 points. And it comes here again in double overtime. Jalen Ray, top of the key for Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman around the screen, puts it up, left hand blocked by Thomas, saved by Wright Foreman, and it lands on the end line.
Out of bounds.
That one will go back to Towson. Hofstra frustrated because Wright Foreman just let that go out of bounds. It could have gotten a set play off of one shot.
Which is true. Very good point made there, Kenny. Blocked down low. Nice job by Thomas switching over. Wright Foreman maybe trying to do just a little bit too much here in double overtime, getting a little anxious.
So 86-82 Hofstra, 2:08 to go here in double overtime. Fobbs on the near side, up top for Howard, top of the key, guarded by Bowie. Now for Fobbs against Pemberton, near side. 15 on the shot clock, under 2 minutes to go in OT2. Howard drives in with the right hand, no good. Rebound caught by Oyelamo, he gives it to Howard, missed short. So two opportunities for Towson, and they come up empty. Still no points for the Tigers here in double overtime. 1:42 to go. Bowie across the timeline for Wright Foreman. Wright Foreman at the logo. Guarded there by Dotton. Dotton draped all over Justin at the logo. 12 on the shot clock. Taylor comes up, sets a screen. Justin gets around him, drives inside, left hand. No good, it rolls out. Rebound out of bounds. That will go to Towson. And again, we're probably going to get another official review here as that looked to be a questionable play underneath.
Getting to the basket, just not able to finish that lefty layup. But you have to give credit to the big bigs down low for Towson, making sure to make it a very difficult finish for Rice Foreman. He's had the open look. Off the glass right there. We haven't seen the replay just yet, but it's a very close call. Obviously, difficult for the naked eye to see right here on the replay. Look at the left hand. Look what comes through. And the ball. Very close. Play got off the table. Bang, bang, play. They're making a decision. They're going to say it's safe.
Change of possession there coming out of that replay as it was Taylor in there, but looked like it went off Tunstall and out of bounds. So a big opportunity coming here for Hofstra to really, I don't want to say put the game away, but give themselves a really nice cushion, and one that they have not had all game.
They can hit a three.
In overtime. Inbounds play for Ray. Puts up a three. It's good! Jalen Ray with a big three. 89-82 Hofstra. That could be the dagger for the Pride.
5 3-pointers for Ray. Not bigger than that one.
Up top. Dot for Howard. Far side. That's an air ball. Rebounded by Ray. And this one looks to be going the way of Hofstra here. Townsend going to back up into the backcourt. Doesn't seem like they're going to call a foul here. Go for an intentional foul, but pressure right Foreman. Again, no points here in double overtime for Towson. And a very strange play here, not to foul. Right Foreman puts it on the floor to the hoop. Lefty jam! Justin Wright Foreman put a dagger in Towson right there with the left hand. 28 points for Justin on the day. 9-point lead for Hofstra in OT2. Tunstall, baseline jumper, no good, rebounded by Ray, and that'll do it. With 20 seconds to go, Hofstra can just dribble it out. Townsend with no points here in the overtime, a defensive stop from Hofstra this whole entire overtime. And the crowd on their feet here at the MAC to celebrate another Pride win on home court. 4-3-2-1, and that will do it. The Hofstra Pride pick up their 23rd win of the season here in double overtime. They get the win over Towson. Hofstra improves to 15-0 on home court, 13-2 in conference in what was a very close, very competitive game here at the MAC.
Kenny, the Towson Tigers came into the MAC aggressive with energy, very physical, and throughout the entire game it seemed like they were in control. Even when Hofstra had a little bit of a lead, it didn't seem like Hofstra was. Mac was a little bit deflated at certain points, but down the stretch, the Pride got it together and were able to find the right match. They were smart in overtime, Kenny. Defensively, huge stops, like you said. The Towson scoreless in the double overtime. Tremendous accomplishment. And if the Pride wanted to be successful, they knew they needed to get a defensive stop or two, and they turned it on, especially down the half, and some huge performances by the Hofstra Pride that can't be overlooked.
Justin Wright Foreman with really an incredible block there at the end of the game to essentially just set up what was a huge Hofstra victory here in double overtime. We're awaiting Speedy Claxton, assistant coach for Hofstra, to come over. And coach, really just a tough, hard-fought game. I mean, we'll start off with the double overtime. You guys didn't allow a single point. Just what went into that defensive play in double OT?
He kind of stepped up first defensively. We kind of put him on Fobbs in the middle, and I kind of took that action away, and we went from there.
Coach, it seemed like down the stretch, the team really buckled down defensively, but in that second double overtime, how were you able to come together offensively and get some crucial buckets down the stretch?
I mean, we started making shots. That's what it came down to. Like I said, Jalen Ray was huge off the bench. I mean, that three he hit off of the out-of-bounds play was probably the game winning shot for us.
And coach, when you look at this game, I mean, what does it say about your team to win a game like this? Because it wasn't the prettiest game. Everyone talks about how great your offense is, but does it just kind of show how this team's able to win in different ways?
it. I mean, we could win in a variety of ways. I mean, this time we had to win with our defense. Sometimes it's going to be our offense. But, I mean, these kids really buckled down in that second overtime period. And we were fortunate enough to get the win.
And, Coach, what do you say about the home court advantage now? 18 straight victories at the MAC dating back to last season for your team.
Yeah, I mean, your home court, you got to defend your home court. If you win all your home games and usually win at least half of your road games, it's usually to make it for a good season.
Okay, assistant coach Speedy Claxton. Coach, thanks so much.
Congrats on the win.
And again, that was Hofstra assistant coach Speedy Claxton following a 91-82 double overtime win for the Hofstra Pride in what was certainly one of the closest games they played all season.
Absolutely, Kenny. And from the start, it seemed like it was going to be a battle. It was not coming easy for the Hofstra Pride. And you have to give a lot of credit to the Tigers. They sit fifth in the CAA. They know what they have to play for. Once you get past the first team, it's all jumbled in the standings. And they played like a team eager for a victory. But I like the point you made with assistant coach Speedy Claxton. They didn't get the shots to fall, right? Foreman had an awkward game with 8 turnovers. Still found a way to score 28, which is remarkable. But they had those crucial moments in which they came together and they stuck together. And that's important. If you want to win a championship, you have to win in a variety of ways. And when your shots go fall, what are you going to do to respond to that?
And that, I think, is something that's so crucial. I mean, it's something where Hofstra, you know, they definitely showed, I would say, some signs of frustration in that second half, especially when Towson went on that long run. But they pulled it back together, and they found out how they could win this game. And that's something that's so crucial. And I think it's something that when you get to CAA tournament time and you don't know kind of what's going to happen, the ability to win multiple ways is something that is just so crucial. And I think it'll be big for Hofstra as CAA tournament play approaches. So we'll look at a couple of final lines on this game. Justin Wright Foreman, 28 points. He ended up leading, came in second all scores in the game. Brian Fobbs for Towson was first with 29 points. But I think Shaquille Taylor is someone I really want to highlight. 14 points. That's really not even the impressive part. 17 rebounds and 7 blocks. I mean, this guy was all over the court, really played every minute of that second half. It was a huge factor in this Hofstra win.
I mean, it's an old cliche, but when you think our defense into offense, the way the Pride did down the stretch, I mean, play to me, even though they didn't win in one overtime, when Taylor chased down the long rebound, found Bowie, he hit a big three when they were down 5, kept them in this game, and that's because of the heart and hustle by Shaquille Taylor, doing a great job on both ends of the floor, and those blocks, I mean, did they not raise the roof in the match?
Yeah, I mean, that was obviously something that was huge. I mean, it was really impressive. They got the Lions then into it, and really, I think, was a huge factor. We had some big jams on both ends. You know, Pemberton had a couple, had a big dunk, as well as, obviously, Justin Wright Foreman with the dunk that kind of put things away. So, Victoria, to wrap things up, I mean, you have 3 more games here on the schedule for Hofstra. They'll play James Madison here at the MAC on senior night. If you didn't get your tickets yet, not coming out to that game, come out. It'll be a great game, and I think that it'll be really good to honor, obviously, Hofstra's star and one of the best in Hofstra history, Justin Wright Foreman, followed up by Drexel and Udell on the road next week. What are you looking for out of these final 3 games for Hofstra?
Well, Kendall, it's Saturday, emotional game, right? How does the Pride control their emotions? If they get a victory, they at least get a share of the regular season, #1 overall seed. Heading into the tournament, which is a huge advantage the way the CAA is set up. So can the Pride overcome their emotions? Because everyone's going to be emotional. I think Coach Mahalik was the first to say there will be some tears because of just what this entire group means. I mean, Jakeem Taylor for one season has meant so much to the starting 5 and right forward towards how many reps get the contribution and the effort he has put into the program. Crucial for the Pride to focus. After the second, the ceremony's done, get back to action, figure out what you need to do in order to come out victorious. It's going to be a great environment at the MAC. And next week on the road, you have to go into that CAA tournament with confidence. Don't let them lose to the Drexel and Delaware. Delaware sitting #4 in the conference. Finish out strong, get these victories, and head to the tournament feeling hot.
And again, Hofstra wins 91-82 in double overtime here against Towson. They push their home court winning streak to 18 straight. They push their overall record to 23-5. For my partner, Victoria Conway, I'm Kenny Conrad signing off saying have a good night. Thank you for listening and enjoy the rest of your Thursday.